hit a pick. Mute this guy. Oh, me? Do I have to let that one in?
Yeah, this...
That's a call. Oh, you're in.
But, yeah, but you gotta mute it.
Anybody home? Hi, everybody! We're doing a little, we got a little slapback happening on here.
Sounds okay.
But guys, just
bring this down.
Yeah, turn your music off. Somebody's live. Somebody's got the show on live. That's what's going on. Hi.
So, wait.
It's you.
Is it me?
Who is it?
It's your iPad.
It's the iPad.
Well, come over and fix it, somebody. I have it on mute, so I don't know what else I need to do, and I have it all the way turned down. Can you fix
dumbass.
It? Hi, we are here for game night. Here, I want to you. Here, I'll leave this iPad.
I don't know if they're
here.
Hearing the slapback. Are they hearing it?
But we can just use this as my Zoom view. But we are live on YouTube.
Oh yeah, we are cooking.
Wow. Happy TGIF, everybody. Tim Heidecker here. We are. Taking it a low, we're having a little low-key evening tonight. We're just going to play games because
Saturdays
we like having fun.
For the boys.
I'm in the Doug chair. Oh, so this is happening again because, see, it's Zoom's. Zoom.
Do you need it?
I don't, I'd like you to see the.
No, it's just like,
yeah,
turn the volume off on the thing?
Absolutely. It's not letting you? Hold on, try that. Okay. Hey, testing 1, 2. That sounds good. And then, yeah, hi, everybody.
There
sorry about
go.
All that. Let's restart. Let's restart with positive energy.
Jesus Christ.
Where's Tim in the Zoom? I'm not seeing you.
We've got a lot of...
Oh,
let's take a Zoom to see how that situation is going. How about good old...
Oh, I know who we should
Madeline.
Talk
here. Okay. Now I'm hearing music, right?
Yes, I'm
it is
playing music.
That is supposed to be going on. That's fine.
Madeline,
like it.
Hi, what's happening?
Oh,
hello.
We got Madeline.
How are you?
I'm pretty good.
Where is she? Can we see her somewhere? Oh, there she is.
Yeah.
Okay. There we go.
Madeline, is it? Are you on the West Coast or East Coast or where are you again?
I'm in Chi-Town.
Okay, so Central Coast. Central
Central
zone.
Coast.
I don't like being sitting here in the Doug chair. I feel like it's not my responsibility to run the show. And so I don't feel like, I'm like, isn't somebody going to yell at me and tell me what to do?
I feel
can't
very,
zone out and just stare at
Matt's the, not where he's supposed to be. Vic is the only one that should feel like it's
But he's encroaching on my
just another day.
Here.
So, Madeline, we've got some. First of all, we've have some games to pick. We're either here's the choices, folks. We're either going to play Trivial Pursuit of some kind with a Candyland board. That's option A.
Because we don't have the Trivial Pursuit board.
And or we're going to play Scrabble, or a game called Blockus, or a game called Set, or a game called. Rummy, a card game named Rummy.
Or War, too, we could even play.
Or Go Fish.
War.
So
oh, war.
Think about
war.
That. Let that sink in, folks. No, we're not playing video games. We're
no, War is the one where you turn
no,
a card.
No, I'm just telling you. Like,
oh,
in general,
no video
people
games.
Are like, oh, cool,
yeah,
game
War
night.
Is like the endless
yes.
card game.
These are analog games.
No disrespect to Limmy
oh, yeah.
and the gamer community. But we're dads who don't have... console we don't have do you have a console
I do I would love to play it but I don't have time
what do you have console
I've got I've got the Switch and my son is 4 and he's been playing that fairly often just pressing buttons and stuff he mm-hmm. likes it but my wife like limits it to like maybe an hour a day under that so That, and then I have the old, I'm a big Nintendo guy. I have all the Nintendo things. And I have the original, this is very interesting. settle in. Uh-huh. I have the Nintendo Classic, which is the new release of the Nintendo system. And I hacked it, so I have every single Nintendo game on it. There's 500 games on it.
Right.
And I just have fun with it.
Do you understand what the consequences of a bad show tonight are and what Doug is going to bring in?
This chair might be empty next week. Yeah.
He is going to come in so full of himself.
Yeah.
Right. Doug is with is camping. This was the big news.
Yeah,
well,
yeah.
No, we can say now.
Well, yeah.
But
well,
when
he's
the news
married?
No, the news broke on our show.
Right,
from Eric Andre.
Yeah.
Eric Andre confirmed that there was going to be some camping, some mushrooms, and that's where we're at right now.
Right.
That's what's happening right now. So, Madeline, anything else you want to add to the conversation?
I think, do you know what my background is?
In school and, oh.
What?
Where'd you go?
I'm trying to show you my
background. Oh, sorry, I talked and then it cut to me. Is that
a map of some kind. It's,
You have to know it.
I do have to know it? Am I going to feel stupid for not knowing it?
Great hitter. Great.
Mittens?
What does it say? Mittens?
Is it something scene? To do with like a.
Hot C.
The Marx Brothers?
Oh, no.
Man, you're close.
That's Three Stooges.
Yes.
Yeah, that's...
Oh,
I don't,
she's the Stooge.
And they hold on that shot for so long so everybody can read the jokes, right?
Oh, is this when they were in the Hitler episode?
The Hitler one, yeah.
Okay.
You Nazi
and they
spy.
Hold on it like a good 45 seconds so everyone can in the theater can read it. And just
the Totsie.
Yeah, Hotsie, Totsie. It's
just getting a lot of
fun. Awesome. That's awesome.
Someone paid $5 to tell us to play Candyland.
Here's the deal with Candyland. We did the 3-hour QAnon episode on Monday, and then we're saying, let's do this game night. I said, why don't we stay away? Someone jokingly said Candyland. I said, let's not get into that because that's a whole thing with. It's there's something sick about it, you know. but
if we use it because we have no choice,
We're going to use it as a board because we don't have a Trivial Pursuit
I don't have
board.
A Trivial Pursuit
That's
board.
The news.
So,
but before we get to games, folks, thank you, Madeline.
You're welcome.
To celebrate the banning or suspension of Tommy G. I'd like to present my baked ziti, which you know Tommy G's jealous of right now. He's looking at my old, it's not that old, but I want to serve it up to comrades here.
Look at that ziti shot.
And so, yes, I've left Twitter, even though I've tweeted several times since that. I should have brought a serving spoon down as well. Vic, do you want a little bit of this?
Yeah, I'll try that.
So here you go. That's my ziti. That's my mom's recipe.
We're really sharing our COVID tonight, too, by the way.
No forks either?
Yeah, there are forks. I'm using a fork as a serving. Wes, you're not getting any.
That's an abomination of God.
Can't keep doing this. Here you go.
Looks delicious.
It's very good.
What's the is there one sausage? Type of cheese or more than one?
It's ricotta, it's mozzarella, it's parmesan, it's some sweet Italian sausage, and some rouse marinara, and some spinach. So this is this morning, the Daily Beast put out a big article on Tommy G. Turns out he was a bank robber. Did you read that part of the story?
I did read that.
Tommy G.
It was almost a little sad, though, like in a way. You know?
He was a degenerate gambler.
Yeah.
It reads like a Sopranos episode. Right. He's in New Jersey. He's in college.
Yeah, like 22 or something.
He's like Richie Aprile from Sopranos. And he's in college. He racks up all this gambling debt. He doesn't know. The guys, the mob or somebody...
His bookies, like
his
he owed
bookies
a lot
were in
of
the
money.
Mob. Trust
and he was working at the bank. Is that what I read?
Yeah.
Or his friend, or he was, I think.
He was too.
Both were, yeah.
He was friends with the teller, and they like staged a bank robbery, which is just a bank robbery.
Right. But they went way beyond. They were able to get way beyond any other bank robbery ever does, because it was like $260,000 or something. And they're like, that's an absurd amount. Normally there's not that much money, you know, in the teller's, whatever you call it, rack or whatever. So they knew where everything was.
Oh, so they knew it was an inside job.
Yeah, they knew it was an inside job. And he wrote it with his own handwriting, so they were able to trace it to that, I guess. And then
and he referenced his mom, right?
I think, you know, something
like
that.
In the note it said, I'll kill you. I'll kill your mom.
Yeah,
which is like, what bank robber is threatening that?
Right.
Like, I'll kill you. How would you know the bank teller's mom?
Right.
Ridiculous.
So he's rotten to the core.
He's
rotten and dumb.
But, yeah, so I don't think it had anything to do with... Do you guys think it had anything to do with me?
Well, did it happen after the article?
I bet they noticed.
Was it after the article?
His banning? No,
yeah.
The article was about the banning.
It was the article, and then it was banned.
So it must have been the article. Yeah, Twitter
was
like bad press, you know?
Listen, you come my way, you get destroyed.
That's right. It's a lesson.
J.W. Miller has resigned.
What?
He resigned. He resigned.
He conceded before it even...
Wait, did he really step... How did I miss all this?
He stepped down. No, he didn't. I'm just
kidding. I was going to say.
He moved back to Connecticut.
But it seems like he's a little less... People aren't... He's kind of like the news of the week is over for him.
He's old news. He's boring already. He's a one-trick pony. And just like, it's time. We're done.
Let's take another Zoom.
Another Zoom? Let's talk to... I saw somebody from Down Under that we didn't get to last time.
You know what's going to happen? I'm going to fucking eat this whole thing of ziti.
We should have
tonight.
An eating contest.
We need that ziti shot.
In my backyard.
Oh, here's a couple. I see a lot of couples. Let's talk to Koza.
It's Friday night, everybody.
Koza. K-O-Z-A.
Did I have a fork?
Unmute.
Oh, you didn't get a fork?
No, I didn't get a fork. No, sorry. My Z is getting cold.
You're just watching him eat.
You were just not enjoying my Z.
No, now I'm just enjoying your story about Tommy G.
Right. Koza, are you on? K-O-Z-A? Hello?
Hello?
Oh, shit.
Oh shit!
Oh shit!
Hello!
Mute your stream.
Yeah, there they are.
In the land of wonder. The land down under.
What's up, you two? You guys boinking?
Oh yeah. Boinked a little too much.
Whoa.
Oh yeah, hear that. So
what?
They had a baby monitor.
Got
a little baby.
How old?
So now you guys, you guys are very young. How old are you guys?
33.
Yeah, 33.
Oh, that's good.
That's
I think that's good. Yeah.
Honey, mommy, please take me home.
I mean, it's whenever, but so now you're in this place where it's Friday night. You're not going anywhere. You're sitting here hanging out with me.
Yes.
You're filling up your
baby
registry.
Not that you would go out anywhere, anyways. But
what's on your baby registry?
Nothing anymore.
Yeah, nothing. That's long past.
Oh.
I don't buy stuff anymore after about a year.
Vic's
I'm in
ziti
land.
Heaven.
I thought I didn't see the pictures.
Heaven.
I thought the picture that they put up was a ultrasound. I couldn't
That's
see it.
I
My
thought.
Eyes are
oh.
so bad. I was like, oh, it's on the way. So I was like, okay.
Wait, how old's the baby?
She's 16 months.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. Oh, it's, yeah.
Mommy,
so
please.
You're settling
home.
In.
Should have got some wine.
We're all dads here. We can have some parent chat.
Yeah.
Do you have any advice you need, or do you have any questions I can help you?
We got three expert dads here tonight.
Mm-hmm. Well, I wouldn't go that far.
Now, I think our biggest struggle right now is dealing with the baby, socially isolating with a baby. You know,
oh God.
She wants to go up to everybody and pet all the dogs
right.
and talk to everybody, and we have to keep telling her no, stay 6 feet back, and it's horrible. So if you have any advice for that, that would be much appreciated.
Let them pet the dogs. Letting my daughter pet dogs.
Yeah, but
dogs.
In the age of COVID,
she can pet a dog. It's fine. It doesn't.
They pet the dog that's stuck in the hair though? I mean, I don't know.
I think that they carry COVID. They
dogs?
Don't catch
no.
COVID. They don't catch it.
Where are you calling in from?
We're not doctors, too, so
don't
take
our advice.
Are you in a hot zone?
Yeah, I'm in a hot zone. We're in Chicago, so kind
we're
of.
In Chicago.
Two we're Chicago in- calls. This is the time. This is prime time Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Anybody
right.
not from Chicago? Do you know Madeline?
Yeah, we're great friends, actually.
No.
No.
You should pot up. You should pot up and hang out. Yeah. Maybe she has a dog your child can pet.
A dog we won't let our kid touch.
Yeah.
No, that's a tough age. I mean, I don't know what to say. I don't know. Keep them indoors.
What's the age again?
14, 16 months.
16 months.
16 months.
That's settling in.
Mess it up. I'm afraid it's going to mess up her brain. And
it is. Yeah, no, that thing sucks. Yeah, that sucks. Yeah.
But I don't think there's avoiding
are you potted anymore. Up with anybody? You got to pot up with somebody.
You know, okay, we are potting up in 3 weeks with our friends who are also on the Zoom right now. Brian and Kate.
Bring them
Hey, Brian
bring
and Kate.
In. Bring them in.
Yeah, bring them
yeah,
in.
We're FaceTiming with them right now.
All right, we're going to try to find them. How old's their kid? Do they have a kid?
She is pregnant with their first kid.
Well, that doesn't help you. You need someone. You gotta pot up with someone else with a kid. That's
know,
my advice.
I know.
We gotta start playing a game because I'm gonna just start plowing through the Z.
Wait, this is so confusing. There's get someone named Christina Lee in the Zoom.
Oh, that's your
ZD
wife.
Shot.
But it's not my wife.
All right, listen. Confusing. Let's talk to Michelle Stone because poor Michelle's always in the Zoom.
Oh, she.
But
she
is this the friends? Is this the friend? The friends of the?
No.
Oh, we got. Do are we doing?
I'm
that?
Not doing that. I don't care about that friend.
I couldn't find it.
Sorry,
too
guys.
Long.
I tried.
Hey,
moving
come on.
On. Come on.
Michelle Stone, you're on.
I have so many great ideas.
Yellow. Can you hear me?
Yes. What
there
can
we
do
go.
For you, Michelle?
So you dropping any bombshells tomorrow? In the interview?
Uh-oh.
Oh, sorry, folks. Yes, we're doing a. I forgot. We're doing a. There's a. Let me find the email here.
This sounds very specific.
Wow.
I know. Well, the answer is no.
Damn.
Michelle does funny videos. I see your videos on Facebook.
Okay, so here's the details, folks. I don't think this is actually for any public consumption, but which. So wow, this is a pointless thing to mention, but. The Gimli Film Festival up in Canada, somewhere, central Canada, Calgary, or no, Saskatoon or whatever.
I haven't heard of that.
Medicine Hat, we don't know. they're doing a Mr. America screening, and Greg and I are zooming in with a very interesting and respected experimental filmmaker named Guy Madden.
Oh, yeah.
I've heard that name.
He's like one of Canada's... prized possessions.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So I don't know if that's going to be open to the public, though. I think it's for their virtual film festival. But no, there's no, there's nothing happening. There's no news. Nothing is happening, folks. I can't tell you. There. I was hoping to drop some news this week.
Yeah.
And we had something right about to go to press with some announcements, and the Patreon people know what I'm talking about, but I still can't even talk about that. Yeah. It's just it's a real mess. No one's signing off on anything.
Office hours is the only news.
The office hours is actually the only thing happening. There's news every day about office hours. We had a terrific, I thought it was a great episode with Sam Richardson and Deerhoof.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of fun. Mm-hmm. And what is Trump doing talking to that Barstool sports creep?
God,
what's
that? Guy,
is he like
I had to turn
a,
off
is he like a Rogan
minutes.
In waiting, that guy?
He's a creep, but he's a Barstool. He started Barstool, which is just
it's huge.
It's very big.
I don't even know what that
they,
is.
Well, they,
sucks.
They,
it's just
no
a
one would know who Tommy
content.
G is without Barstool because that's where he started.
He was
talk
a
to me what this what is this Barstool?
I don't totally know. I think it's like sports gambling.
No,
isn't it like a whole like
well,
thing about?
Had, I can explain.
They
it.
They cover it.
Are right? you on mic enough?
Am I? Can
Matt,
you hear me? Am
is
I too
Matt
low?
On mic enough?
I feel like I'm okay. I'm too much. Maybe I'm pushing it.
It's a whole network.
A
and
network. Why don't we have a network?
Tommy G
like actually
did
on cable?
Fantasy sports. No, like a media network.
Oh, okay.
And they have podcasts. There was that controversy with these two women who had a podcast. And
well, women shouldn't have podcasts.
Well,
it's a men's game.
That may be the case. But they have, you know, websites and crappy shows, and
right.
they're just
they
like...
They steal everything they post.
They're one
of
these
tons
fuck
of
Jerry
stuff.
Types.
Yes.
But bigger and worse.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it's sports related.
Isn't it?
It has to be.
No.
They're called Barstool Sports.
They're big Don Jr. fans. That's like a big thing. Yeah, the Saturdays for the Boys is from them. That's where that originated.
Uh-huh. What is that?
Like, I did a video of it, and they have all these, like, MAGA people, and they just go up to him and say, Don Jr., what's Saturday for? and he'll think, and it's like, you can see the wheels turning.
Dead mouse in his brain.
Yeah. The Boys! And that's it. Uh-huh. And that's Saturdays for the Boys, because you leave the ladies at home, and you go out. And
go to the cigar bar.
Right, you come here, you play Trivial Pursuit, and ziti. That's what it's all about.
What is their... How do they make any money? What is it's all ads
stealing
and branding?
People's stuff and posting with ads. I'm sure that's what it is. Like
that's the other
fuck
gross
Jerry
thing
model.
About that particular main guy. He's always posting like from his pool in Martha's
cool.
Vineyard.
That's awesome.
Pretending to be a man of the people, and it's just gross.
I mean, between this and Rogan with that Shapiro interview was crazy, but. And then there's this Tim Pool that I see. And what happens is I'm getting interested in this stuff because I'm sort of just seeing what's going on out there. Mm. And my YouTube now is completely screwed.
Oh, yeah.
My algorithms have been completely corrupted.
You're fucked.
And so I've got Tim Pool's live show every day telling you got these Weinstein brothers. Oh, or the, what are they called?
I'm getting the Weinstein brothers.
Weinstein, yeah. Eric and Brent and Trent and Joe Rogan and Tim Pool. And
you're in the algorithm now.
And then now I'm getting all these Anthony Cumia.
Oh, yeah. Compound Media, Gavin McGinnis, all
these, fan videos. And they're just, you look at the numbers and you're like, I got to hang it up.
It's just like the rabbit hole.
Yeah, it's the rabbit hole. You're exactly in the rabbit hole.
Yeah, you're going.
And I'm getting red pilled, man. They're making a lot of sense.
Yeah, right. Oh, no.
Everything. There's cancel culture happening. And look what's happening up in Portland.
Right, right.
Which is insane. I mean, people have to be reined in.
Right.
And, maybe we need to start cracking skulls.
Right. Yeah.
But let me read that. And then you actually watch it, it's actually so boring. But what is this Tim Pool? He's probably on live right now. Let's see, because he was earlier.
I have a good Tim Pool video.
He has this sidekick. It's got to be one of the dumbest people I've ever seen. What's his name? It's the funniest name, too.
I don't know
what
his name is, but... He just has a... The Capitol Hill
Autonomous Zone is where is this
he's
guy?
He's just always complaining.
It's this live guy. He's so funny. I took a picture of him. He's also wearing a beanie.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
His name... He's got the funniest name.
The beanie bun.
Oh, yeah, here it is. Adam Krigler. Adam Krigler? And he's like, they all mask as sort of like these woke libs or something. But
like, I know,
he's got like long hair and a beard.
Like I remember years ago, somebody like
Krigler.
Tim Pool was like, he goes to these protests and he films people protesting hate groups, like somebody like the Proud Boys or whatever will come to town or Charlottesville. Tim Pool will go there and he'll film, Antifa and anybody protesting. He gets in their faces and everybody knows who he is because he's framing them. He's just trying to set them up. So somebody goes up to him and at the point and just pulls his hat off, his beanie off, like which he never does.
He's
and he flips, he loses
brain.
His shit. Yeah, and he just wears it because he's going bald or whatever. Who cares?
Yeah.
But he flips out. He's like, I wear this because I'm trying to hide my face and people don't know what I look like without my beanie on. And then months later, he's selling T-shirts with beanies on.
It's all branded.
It's just branded.
That's
shit.
What's wrong with it, like.
Yeah.
Tommy G, all these guys are like, they're trying to create a brand. I mean,
course,
we all do it.
Of course,
we all
just,
do it.
Yeah, just like.
But.
Just these phones.
That's not, the brand isn't the problem per se. It's just the disingenuous glomming on to real bad stuff.
The bad faith.
Right. Here's a good Tim Pool clip for you.
Thank you.
See if this how this works. This is Tim Pool bragging about his experience with dating apps.
And now I'm in my 30s. And I can go on dating apps and be like, oh, yeah, yep, mm-hmm. You got it. And then these other guys who are like 26 have no experience mm-hmm. because guys like me have dominated the dating apps the entire time.
Yeah. Like, that's where his head is. Like, he's like on another planet.
Like,
yeah,
Krigler's like, yep.
Right.
No, totally, I agree. I agree.
Dominating the whole time.
Krigler's always just going like, no, you're right. I mean, you're right. Say anything, Vic, and I'll be Krigler.
Krigler. It's really hot in here, but your
no,
beanie
right.
still looks
I mean,
good.
Listen, I mean, you're right.
Good ziti.
Yeah, ziti's good. I got a lot of it on my computer now. All right, let's take a call and talk about what game we should play.
Oh yeah, what was the
Who
first
has opinions on games? Make some, you know, wave your arms around or something. Someone's holding up Monopoly, which we don't have.
Can you imagine good. If we played Monopoly?
Luke, you have opinions, Luke? Luke Smith.
Yeah. What's up, guys?
What's going on, Luke?
Do you guys have Pictionary?
We gave you the choices, didn't we?
I'm a little late to the party.
Right, there's probably reiterate. a way to fake it.
Here's where we're at. We have the questions for various Trivial Pursuit games.
A lot of questions.
Just random fucking cards.
Yeah.
Not just random fucking cards. But we don't have the board itself, so we were going to co-opt the Candyland board to use, which seems like a good idea. Why don't we just do that?
Yeah.
I like that.
And then
idea.
We can bail on that.
Yeah.
And, you know, eventually, maybe should we bring in, how do we want to include the audience? Is there any way to do that?
We could ask them a question. They could be a lifeline, or they could be.
You can do polls on Zoom, too, pretty sure.
Oh, we can do a poll on them? That's complicated.
I'm pretty sure you can.
Well, let's get a starter question, Vic. Warm me up here.
Well, don't we need the board?
We do, but why don't you clear the...
Let's put this ziti away.
Thank you, ziti. Let's hear it for ziti.
Excellent. Oh, you want to get one more ziti shot.
One more ziti shot. Bye, Tommy G. Good luck with whatever you do next.
Okay. Question for...
nice work there.
Yeah, you like that?
Doing the drops and doing the game master.
And sweating in my head here. What Beach Boys ditty mentions the surfer stomp and a surfboard losing wax?
Got to be Surfing in the USA.
Close.
Surfing Safari.
Who's on the call here? Ian.
Luke.
Luke, you got it? You got an answer for that?
Oh, do I need to unmute somebody?
Shit. Are you familiar with the Beach Boys?
Yeah, my dad likes them.
Well, your dad does, but... What was the first Beach Boys song?
He's like, my granddad likes them.
Yeah, right. What's the first song they wrote together and it was a hit?
Fuck.
What Beach Boys did he?
Surfing Safari.
No.
What?
Surfing.
Oh, just surfing.
They're surfing, yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
Everybody played surfing.
Surfing is ba-ba, dip-da-dip-da-dip, ba-ba, dip-da-dip-da-dip. Early in the morning, I turn on my radio. There it is.
Wow, all right. What's this? Look at this guy's Zoom. His house is on fire. Shit, look at that.
Wait, his is too. Cartoon?
What's
Ian, what's his name? I'm bad with names. What's his name again? What's your name again?
Luke.
That's not that hard of a name to remember, but.
I'm a huge fan, guys. I listen to Office Hours all the time. I'm really
excited, man.
To get called.
Cool.
I have one of my first DVD purchases was Tom Goes to the Mayor. So
what?
Big fan.
Thanks for being my big fan. I appreciate that a lot. It's been
thanks to everybody all the nice messages we've gotten about the latest all the shows we've been doing. We're building a very nice community. Of decent people, not these pool heads.
Doug is
Doug's camping.
Too cool for game night.
Doug's camping.
He wanted to be here, and I said, you know what? Let's just. I figured this is going to be a shitty show. The first game night's going to be a bad. We're going to learn lessons from this. Sort of like Paul McCartney's first solo album. You know?
Well, my buddy, and I are big fans, and he's texting me, and I was a little late, but he said. All Tim's doing is eating baked ziti. Yeah.
That's not all I'm doing.
It's not all. It's good.
I mean,
it's one thing.
It's one of the things I've been doing.
It's a little rude.
All right, so
we talk to somebody else.
Go ahead. Let's talk. Let's keep the conversation going. Like
the phone lines. Record,
ladies and gentlemen, the phone lines are open. I watched a little bit of. By the way, I haven't checked in on him in a while. I watched a little Alex Jones.
Because, well, how did you do that?
Because my algorithm is completely
screwed.
I want to see if I can, if it's in my history here. Let's see how low his voice has gotten. it's like
it's wait, all gravel. It's turning into Mutombo.
But also his studio is insane. Like,
yeah, there's a lot going on there.
There's
it's pretty impressive.
Like, yeah, there's all these jib shots. Mm-hmm. Alex Jones full show, maybe. There's shots every 2 seconds. Like, he's moving. Like,
right.
This is from.
We're going to be hearing from Alex coming up.
Oh, that other guy's hosting right now.
With some breaking news.
That's no good.
This guy's still on the, you know, with the deal. The
Oh, is that the kid, Owen Schroyer?
Yeah.
We saw him at the RNC, I remember.
Where's Alex? He's got not on the show today. Here he is.
He sounds like he just woke up. Apartment building. That's right.
Where is he? Alex.
I heard him for a sec. I have an, you know who, I have an idea for you, Vic. You ever watch any Jim Cramer?
Of course, yeah. Uh-huh.
I'd like to see more of him. What? He's so crazy.
I want his soundboard. He's got like all kinds of, well, he's not even around anymore. Is he on there anymore?
He's still on the air, isn't he? Oh, this is a bummer. I'm sorry. I was watching a full show and it's like, it's the big highest production value news show I think I've ever seen. It's this massive studio. There's like 40 different angles that they use. But I don't know where he is.
Where's Jack? Someone, this is a perfect opportunity for Jack the Idiot Dunce if his question stinks.
I'm getting it ready, buddy. I got the
You got it ready?
Idiot
Where's
drop.
Jack S? Where's Jack S?
Better be good if your name's Jack.
Jack S, where are you?
Dumb bastards.
Yeah, where is he?
Who are you trying to get to?
Someone's, you know, they DM me in the chat on the Zoom.
Man, I just realized how bad my eye. I haven't been to the eye doctor in a long time, and I have to squint like hell to see anything. It's not good.
All right, let's get the game started, okay?
You're talking about eyes now.
What color should I be, everybody? Green. I'm wearing green. I should be green.
And where we should probably say where that came from, that shirt. Right?
I bought this at a Goodwill.
No. It's fucked up. Oh, you can get those on Rock and Pins.
Rockandpins.com. And yeah, we were.
Hello.
We had a.
Hold on, Jack. Give us 1 second.
Jack,
one
hold second. On. Excuse we had an incident because we did our show, we did our game with Mauricio and we had some miscommunication. We didn't give proper plugs.
Yeah.
And feel bad about that. So we apologize.
Unintentional.
We did. I mean, we did. Let's be honest. We did plug the website.
But there was a lot going on. And we
there was a lot going on with Deerhoof.
We get distracted
Greg
easily.
Greg guy was out of his mind in a
who's
good
this?
Way. Greg from
Oh,
Deerhoof.
Yeah. Yeah. In the best way. And somebody's drawing. And
somebody's drawing.
Playing
and
games.
We just didn't get a proper plug. So rockandpins.com. Is where you can get this shirt.
And
I love it.
Actually, raised all this money
shirt.
For. It's comfy,
it's
right?
It's pure silk.
I mean, I'm not.
it's pure silk.
It's nicer. I must say, it feels nicer than the office hour shirt. I must say.
It's
softer.
Listen
softer.
To this.
Not,
I had
not
this
shit on us. You know.
You don't like the mug. You don't like the shirt. I get it.
I know.
I
get it.
Had this shirt appraised today. I took it down to my t-shirt dealer.
Uh-huh.
And he said, because this was something like, whatever. How much? What is it? 20 bucks? Something
25.
Like 25 bucks. Yeah. He said this shirt's worth 200-300 bucks easy.
Wow. If you wear it, if you wear it.
No, I'm saying it just from, just in general.
Just in general. It's rare. Said, they are running out.
He had his jewelers. He had these two, he put
inspecting
two jewelers.
You for moth holes and
in,
stuff.
And he went, wah? He just, wah? Hoo, wah? Where'd you get this shirt? I said, it was a gift from Rock and Pins, from Vic.
Couldn't
said,
believe
this shirt,
it.
What'd you, he's like, what'd you pay for this shirt? I go, 25 bucks. Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck. He went, that's a $300 shirt, dude.
So get them now. They're still, as while thing. They're 25.
Go ahead, sir. What do you want?
Jack.
What do you want, Jack?
Jack.
Oh,
Jack made it. All right.
Jack Mayhoffer.
He already has a Jack S. Long time listener.
What are you, Tim Pool with that hat on? What are you, Popeye?
It's my beanie. First time caller from Australia. Thank you very much.
What part?
I'm Tim and Vic. I'm from Melbourne, actually.
Love
it.
Nice.
Yeah, love
hold
it.
On. Let me drop this real quick.
Hold on. There you go.
That's your favorite band, right? Men at work.
I love Ry Cooter and I love Tim Heidecker. I've messaged Tim on Instagram, but I never heard back. Unfortunately, he's a busy guy.
I don't really look at the Instagram direct messages.
There's too much going on.
Actually, I have a musical question for Tim. It's not really trivia, but sadly, Emmett Rhodes died this week as well, which was but I, on more positive terms, I'm a musician myself, and last year, Tim, you posted on your Instagram a song that is in my head probably daily, which is the Laundry Basket song, and I have a question as to whether it goes, riding in the laundry basket. It's a question from one of your kids, I believe, and I wonder if you're going to release that or put that into maybe album number two.
Yeah,
seems like you should.
I guess so.
You know,
you should do a kids album. Kids, I mean,
this is some Emmett Rhodes, real quick though. Let me just dig
beautiful.
This.
Pump it up. Is there a way to get that? There we go.
It's good. I mean, it's so lovely.
Yeah, it's perfect.
Very Beatles.
Everything about this album is perfect.
I mean, it's a very, very McCartney. Very McCartney.
Yeah. And all recorded himself, apparently. Right. All tracked himself.
Parents' basement.
Yeah, yeah, total savant, mm-hmm, genius. How did you know? How did you find out about him, Vic?
I just know a lot of stuff. I'm just very familiar with music. I knew him a long time.
You're going to beat me at Trivial Pursuit music. You know, that song you're talking about, I honestly don't know if I know what you're talking about.
In the laundry basket, you filmed it yourself on your phone. You made it up in the morning, yeah, and you said it's the laundry song or something. And
did I put it on Instagram? Is that how you saw it?
Yeah, Instagram.
Okay.
Yeah. But it's a great melody.
I do that every once in a while. I put up a song on Instagram, but I don't ever finish it. I should put out a compilation of those unfinished songs.
It's a goof. It's a quick goof, but it's early on.
When I was on tour that was about. Please send balloons. You know that one?
I don't think so. Backstage on the piano, I think remember, but I can't remember.
It was like In Lieu of Flowers. Yeah, that was a great song. It's like, in lieu of flowers, please send balloons. Please send balloons. Da 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 da. Please send balloons.
I remember that now. Yeah.
In lieu of flowers, please send balloons. By the way, I'm working on there was the John Early song from the other day.
Oh, yeah.
And that was a big hit. And
I mean, you could take that and run with it.
But what happened was the producer, Mark Ronson.
Yes.
Big
hot shot Taylor Swift.
He's a hot producer. He's a big fan of John Early, and mm-hmm, I guess John Early posted the song I wrote, and Mark Ronson loved that. So loved more. It's about John Early that he loved. It's like, I didn't realize I could make a song about John Early. So then he made a song about John Early.
Do you want me to pull it up?
Mark Ronson's.
Is that like, or do you not want to promote
I'd be happy to hear it. Yeah,
Competing John song.
The Laundry Basket song is very kind of Randy Newman. It's very
That's no surprise. It's all I can do.
Happenstance. So you do it good.
There's been some special job. This is Mark Ronson's John Early song.
There's a legend, and the legendary ones. What they make Clementine some Clements. You make jokes appear to nothing, like the mold on the old muffin.
Your mind pains
to bring us laughter.
Like it's very
first rodeo.
Midnight Vultures.
I brought your Netflix show.
God, I love that album. It's great.
Your YouTube clip, shout out Kate 555.
Yes.
I really gotta watch Search Party. It's just kinda daunting, cause I left it too late and you're on season 3. But I find time, because I love your stuff. You know I love your stuff now. Ooh,
I tweeted him.
Shit, this is a dog.
Here's my question about this video. Do you think he edited it himself, or you think he like has a guy?
I mean, he could have a guy. I wish I had a guy. Yeah. I got you.
You kind of have a guy, actually.
Now I've got a guy.
Got some guys. Got some guys.
I have less guys.
You need some gals. You need some gals in this.
Some gal or a gal.
So
you know
before you guys came over, I'll give you a little sample of what I'm working. John Early is never late. Because John Early is so great. The song I wrote for him got the attention of Mark Ronson. Number one producer in the land. Now it looks like I'm gonna be recording in a New York City with the number one producer in the land. But this part I think could be really cool. I'll let it go. I wonder if he's related to David Bowie's right-hand man. Wait, I can't hear myself very well. Hold on. I wonder if he's related to David Bowie's right-hand man. I should look into that before we jam. I should know more about him before we enter a working relationship. I should know more about him before we enter a working relationship. I should know more about him before we enter a working relationship. All I know is we're gonna be writing songs about John. I want to get this part right though. I wonder if he's related to David Bowie's right-hand man. That's what I want to do melodically, Vic. I wonder if he's related to David Bowie's right-hand man.
Right-hand man.
You know what I'm talking about? Mick Ronson.
Mick Ronson. That's clever. Yeah, yeah.
So I got to sing it lower. I wonder if he's related to David Bowie's right-hand man. I should look into that before we jam. I should know more about him before we enter a working relationship. I should know more about him before we enter a working relationship. All I know is we're gonna be writing songs about John. Songs about John. Right?
Yeah. Do a whole album of John songs. I mean, there's a lot of Johns.
There's a lot of Johns to like.
That's a great
idea.
I wonder if he's related to David Bowie's right-hand man.
Get into some, like, bathroom songs, too. The John.
I think that's gonna be good, right, guys?
Should we get some feedback from a Zoomer?
Sure.
We have to talk to Christina Lee. Yeah, sure. It's kind of funny.
People liked it.
Hi, Christina.
Hi.
How's it going?
It's good.
Is this your
How
Christina?
Are you?
It's not.
Yeah. Not oh, it's not. Kind of funny. This isn't.
I heard my name earlier, and I kind of freaked out. I'm a little freaked out right now.
Are you too nervous to
Where
talk?
Are you calling in from, Christina? Hi.
I'm from Oakland, California.
Groovy.
What's going on in Oakland tonight?
I love when Vic feels the obligation to fill the air.
Fill the air.
Wait, when sorry. I don't really understand what is why I felt like I was maybe someone thought I was somebody
You're
else.
Being single. My wife's name is Christina Lee.
Oh, okay.
So
cool.
It's
so
kind of
cool.
funny.
This
I mean,
is weird.
Whatever. It's not
this is
good.
Weird.
It's dead air.
How can we help you today, Christina? What's your Friday night looking like?
It's going good. I'm Terrible working from life. Home a lot. I've been quarantining kind of since March, so I haven't really left my home a lot in the past since March.
Are you by your lonesome there?
Coronavirus.
No, I'm with my partner Zach. I was talking to him earlier about a guy Madden mentioned, and I think when I first met him, he kind of showed me a guy Madden film, which was really cool.
And you're like, this is
yeah,
the man
I'm a
for
nervous.
Me.
Which guy Madden film?
It was the What was that film?
The one, there's one with Isabella Rossellini, right? Slap.
Isn't there another Guy Madden who makes like
shoes?
Like video games. Video game.
That's
guy.
John Madden. That's John Madden. All right. Christina Lee, I'm sending all my love.
Oh, that's
to
a good
you.
Song. We should do that one.
What about John D? He's got this guitar. Do you want to do a cover of my new song that I just wrote?
Where is he?
Can you figure it out?
Is your if I make you
see, isn't that catchy?
That's very catchy. Very catchy.
Where are you seeing John D? Is it towards the front?
Hold on.
I wonder if he's related to David Bowie's right-hand man. I wonder if he's related to David Bowie's right-hand man. I should find that out before we jam.
John D, you're on too.
Now it looks like I should know more about him before yep. we enter a working relationship.
Yes, John D.
Hey.
Johnny D.
What's up, Johnny D?
It's a good Emmett Rhodes song.
Am I coming in clear?
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, man?
Not much.
Speaking of Johns, we got another John to sing about.
There he is.
There we go.
I was up in the mountains the other day.
You're looking what?
I was up in the mountains the other day and I saw one of your stickers.
What?
What stickers? Office hours?
One of these ones.
Holy cow.
On the mountain.
Oh, somebody posted. Somebody posted.
It's like on a pole.
Really?
I'm not surprised. Yeah.
The derelict to watch this show.
That's 10 years in jail if you get Seriously. Caught if it's on public land now. It's
what state?
Violating
what state were the mountain?
Trump found that.
Monuments?
Yeah, he found that old. He said, I found an old log. We went digging. And now somebody puts paint on a statue or public
pole or
land.
Pole. Even poles.
Even a pole.
Really?
Automatic 10 years. That's what he said.
For real?
He's full of shit, of course.
Where was the yeah. Where was the pole? What
pole?
In Colorado.
Wait, was it on a mountain or a pole in a mountain?
You guys.
It's like there's some random poles out there in the mountains from Why mining.
Okay.
Like Polish people? Sort of
like a metal pole. Just
I was walking around, I saw a pole.
Green
I mean, it was like after point. Climbing like 1,000 feet at least.
Wow.
Wow.
Well, thanks for spreading the word, but I'm not surprised. Don't be all surprised that we have
it was cool
fans
it,
out
though.
There, okay? Yeah. It's a very popular show.
I don't approve of that sort of that's graffiti, essentially.
Defacement of property. Defacement. Yeah, all right, nice. Here we go. The game has begun.
What's
the matter?
The game, though?
Mr. Walsh is wondering if you should call in.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Why not? I think I gotta dump somebody from the Zoom. It's full.
Oh, really? Well,
that's fine.
Well, to somebody
make, can't
we
you like
to
make
already.
It? Can't like 100? How many people can just?
100.
It's kind of mean.
You know, there's people
fire
that think
people?
Like I saw one. I mean, nobody thinks that Brendon Walsh calls for real the other day, right?
No.
I mean,
some people
was that real?
Yeah.
Like, come on.
Well, the bank robbery people. Some people.
Some
that one.
Like, I got a lot of shit for that because people were like. But that was I thought that was really rude the way that they talked to that woman.
People
like,
fell for this what's his name? The Sklar. What's the guy's name? The bass player dude.
Oh yeah.
Oh,
some
Leland.
Thought that was
Leland. That was great. That was good though.
But
I mean, I think sometimes it's just they like to fuck with us and
that
be
could
like,
be too.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they're like, I can't believe you fell for the fact that you thought that I didn't think you
right,
fell for it. I've been making great rice lately, everybody. You want some tips on rice?
Oh, man, I do. Yeah, I love rice. I'm a big rice guy.
I look, you know that Alton Brown?
No.
Alton Brown.
Alton Brown, yeah.
He's great.
I used to watch his show all the time. It was a fun show.
He has a video, and it was like a very simple rice recipe, and I was like, I need a solid rice recipe.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so easy, and it works every time, and they come out great, Vic.
Yeah. I'm just getting a drop ready. I can multitask.
Saucepan, two cups of rice with some tablespoons of butter.
Mm-hmm.
Toast the rice in the saucepan with the butter.
Sure. Right.
Right. Meanwhile, you've got your hot water kettle. Yeah. You got your water kettle boiling away with three cups of water.
How can
three
it,
cups
is
of
toasted
water.
Though? How
yeah,
can it
yeah.
cook?
That's all right.
No, listen to me.
All right. All right.
Medium high heat. You're toasting the rice with the butter. It's get
raw rice
good.
Toasting.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just you're just sauteing the rice.
Browning a little bit.
Yeah. You're not even browning it. You're just kind of
toasting it.
Toasting it.
getting a little crisp.
And meanwhile, you got 3 cups of water going in the kettle.
Boiling, yeah.
But boiling. And as soon as it boils, and you got a little, the butter's melted.
Uh-huh.
It's pretty intense. But you take the lid off, or you don't have the lid on, but you have a lid ready.
Right.
You pour in the boiling hot water, 3 cups, into the saucepan, and it's like an explosion of sound and steam.
Uh-huh.
It's very violent.
So it doesn't take less time than normal, right?
Then you close the lid on it, turn the heat down to low, and 20 minutes.
That's not bad at all.
20 minutes, don't touch it.
That cuts it in half, probably.
And then you open it up and fluff it with the fork.
Holy shit.
It is...
Holy shit.
A little salt.
Well, I remember you've always talked about rice. I remember when we went to the RNC, we're staying in all these Airbnbs, and we would just get shitty Chinese food or whatever. Just
disrespectful.
I know, it was rude. I apologize. Let's cut that, hit the dump button or whatever. But you would have all this extra rice, is what I'm saying.
Right.
And I remember we were like cooking.
I know what you're saying. Yeah.
I was cooking eggs, and you're like, you know, what would make that better? You plop the rice in.
Rice and eggs.
It's so good.
And now my wife taught me a new thing with rice, because we had all this extra rice from making the good rice. Because
you just like to make it. You'd like to toast it. Yeah.
So for breakfast, we do that. We advance the rice and eggs move.
Mm-hmm.
What we did is you put a little oil in a frying pan. You put the leftover rice in the frying pan with a little tapatio or some kind of...
I don't even know what that is.
Maybe
what
some hot sauce.
Oh, a little, pineapple.
What's it called?
I'm a big board... Bravado spice. Which I had right before I came. On a burrito.
You put that in the frying pan, fry that up, and then crack a couple eggs over that.
Yes.
And then let it cook for a while, because then the rice gets real crispy.
Right.
You get a crispy rice.
Crispy rice. I'm into that. I like mixing it with coconut milk too.
Coke. Oh well, you do. Yeah, if you do coconut oil and rice, you're in heaven.
Oh yes, coconut milk, rice and oil.
All right.
All right. Now
Matt's left the show. Matt left.
The show is over
again.
Wes, take over. Come on over, man. Wes is here too, by the way, everybody. Let's give Wes a round of applause. He's been doing amazing work. See if I can get the crowd sound going here.
Another guitarist over here. By the way, anybody listening to the Beatles Solo Years podcast I've done, I did an episode on George, and I was proved correct about something that I said that Eric Clapton plays the very first guitar part on I'll Have You Anytime, the first song on the album, All Things Must Pass.
How'd you find that out then?
I know, because I can hear. Because I know.
You just know that tone.
Yeah. And Eric Natornacola pushed back.
Oh, okay.
He said, I don't know. I think that might be George. Then today, I found an interview with George Harrison where he says, the that very first note is Eric.
Sounds pretty amazing. Cool. Yeah.
All right. Should we play the game?
You're right.
Or do you want to take another? Yeah, let's take another Zoom call and start the game.
Get them involved in the game, right?
Absolutely.
All right. Let's talk to Duncan. Hey, Duncan Carey.
As long as it's not Duncan Trussell.
Hey, what's up, CD boys?
He's banned.
We're banning all right.
Hey, who's this?
Duncan.
Oh, hey,
Duncan. Hi, ZD boys. Can you hear me?
What's up, Duncan?
How's it going?
My Dodgers are in town. Look at that.
Yeah. Watching the game right now. I got two things going at once. Got two games on my screen.
Did you guys see that video of the Fox Sports preview of what the games are going to be like with the audience, where it's like that...
Like CGI.
The CGI crowd.
It's bananas.
We can't put that up on the screen, can we?
Why would they do that?
It's insane.
The Dodgers did like the cardboard cutouts where you like paid for cardboard cutouts, and they have one of Stephen Brody Stevens out there.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah, we mentioned that the other day.
Thanks to Rockin' Pin set that up.
But did we... so do they have Mary Hart and Larry King?
Mary's there.
Is she?
I haven't seen them yet. I've been keeping an eagle eye on everyone. So,
what's the score?
I'll keep an eye out. Max Muncy just hit his second home run. I'm watching it on slight delay. So it's 6-1 right now. They're kicking ass.
Now, I've become a big baseball fan, but I feel like I'm just going to sit out this season or something. It feels very weird. I got so into the Dodgers, and I watched every game last year pretty much, which is not easy to do, and I probably didn't.
but then they flopped so badly
in that postseason. They flopped in the first round.
Yeah, it was disappointing.
To say the least.
2 years ago, I fell in love with them. I was working with Postmates at the time, and I listened to all their playoff games on the radio. So that's what
I love it. Hooked. I love baseball.
Anybody need a?
Sure, I'll take a.
But yeah, I'm excited for the game, and I was going to say it's kind of an unprecedented move, but I was willing to answer the first question for you or Vic, if you're willing to let me.
Yeah, that's fine. You'll be
pursuit.
You're wearing blue. So you're blue.
So he's playing for
I'm team
me.
Blue.
I have a blue shirt.
You and him are on the same team.
Did you go right. yet?
No, we haven't started
the
game.
Started. Oh, who's asking the questions? Vic.
Vic is starting by asking
with me.
We actually did. We did a.
We did a preliminary.
Preliminary test round, but now I'm green. Vic is red, and
me and Duncan are blue.
You and Duncan are blue.
Ask us a question, Vic.
Okay, Brendon's gonna be emailing you.
Zooming in.
He's gonna emailing.
Okay. Let's see. I can just pick any on this card, right?
Doesn't sure.
Hmm.
Sure.
Well, how many? Hold on.
Wait. Oh, wait.
This Candyland board. I mean, I think maybe. Do we have a dice?
That would be helpful.
What do you mean? No, it's colored. So if I get.
No, but we have to get a dice and then land on a color, and then that's what he reads.
But they're not going to line
same
color.
It's if you get it right, you advance.
Calm down. Listen to me. We have to roll a dice.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Is there like a random or number randomizer or something?
No. Here's what we'll do. I'll call out somebody in the Zoom to say a number.
They can say a number.
There you go.
Up to five or something.
Or they hold up fingers.
Okay, ready? Connor, give it to me. Hold your fingers up. Two.
Oh boy.
Okay.
So I go one, two.
I'm going
first. Oh, no. You only go if you get it, right?
But I go first.
Or you go two. Okay. That was three.
That's three. He's already cheating.
Get his shot on this. This
Wait.
Is not.
Oh, I. Okay. One, two. Okay. Purple.
Look at this guy.
All right. Purple. I don't have a purple, but anyway.
What's I'll just to purple?
That's pink. Pink will
okay.
be purple.
Okay. Here we go. What alto sax great waxed bird get the worm, blue bird, and bird feathers?
What alto sax great?
You'll know this.
Kenny G?
Excuse me.
I thought you were on my team.
Yeah,
Duncan.
You're not playing.
Son of a bitch.
Oh, sorry.
You're with Matt.
You're my lifeline.
But I was going to guess Kenny G. But
what were you going to guess? You're going to guess Kenny G? This is Kenny probably wasn't even around at this
time. Oh, okay.
Time.
No. So
it's a jazz great.
This yeah, Charlie Parker.
There you go.
Yeah, Bird.
There it is.
Doi.
All right, I go again.
You go again?
Yeah. I go until I lose.
All right.
What?
Here we go. Let me see. Ruth, give me a number 1 to 5. 3.
Okay.
1, 2. Orange.
Orange.
Okay.
John Spencer Blues Explosion album. It's called Orange.
What's the title of Janis Ian's first and 10th albums? wait, think about it though. Think about it.
I'm gonna guess Janis Ian.
That's it. That's the one. So he doesn't go. Oh, gets to go again. He's just gonna dominate.
Ruth, give me another number. You're my lucky charm.
Dominating the Candyland.
No rules that say yes, 4.
Let's let Ruth in. Where is she?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Is that a pinker? Let's see.
Ruth, you're on my team now.
Is Ruth?
She'll be your lifeline also. Oh, here, I'm going to unmute you, Ruth. Say hello.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Ruth.
Okay.
Hi.
What did Frank Sinatra get in 1940 for recording I'll Never Smile Again? And there's a multiple
herpes.
Choice.
No. You probably not did.
$25, $250, or $2,500? 1940.
It's in $1940?
$1940.
What are the choices?
25, 250, or 2500?
25. What do you think, Ruth?
I was going to say 250, but
Where was Frank Sinatra in his career at that point? I mean, 1940?
He's doing okay. Right? Yeah,
that's pretty early for him, though. That's pretty early.
You wouldn't know better than
me, okay. To be perfectly honest.
Shoot. Well, I'm going with 225, first number.
25 it is.
Yeah! Yeah! Come on!
This train don't stop, Ruth. Give me another rigged. One. Give me another one. Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Give me another number, Ruth. Come on, give me something good.
I need Doug here so I can get
give me something good.
I can be. You want me to do the questions?
Some, no. It's okay. Ruth, give me a number. Do the drops, and then I like to have music going too. It's just
Oh, right.
So wait, are we moving the piece along the board?
Yeah.
If we get a correct answer.
Yeah. Yes, Ruth. What's can the, I? Have a, what? But I need you to give me a number from 1 to 5, just randomly.
Yeah. Five.
Another 5.
This is if we're moving. This is like, yeah. Everyone's just gonna pick 5, so their guy wins.
Yeah.
This game stinks.
This game is awesome.
So what do you?
No, it's meant to be random. But you're right. That doesn't make any sense.
What is that? Red or orange?
Red.
I can't see. Okay.
Everybody, don't just the first number that comes to your head.
It'll move along right, faster this, if it's always. Five,
this
so
might.
Maybe
this
not true, the yeah. worst.
This might end it for Tim here.
Hopefully.
What symphonic instrument shriek can be heard over the loudest orchestra?
It's an instrument?
Yeah. What symphonic instrument's shriek can be heard over the loudest orchestra?
Like that?
He's on to it.
It's got to be a trumpet.
Your final answer? Though?
A piccolo trumpet.
Final answer.
What was the first thing you said?
A trumpet.
Yeah, he said trumpet.
It was a piccolo.
I said a piccolo.
No, he said a piccolo trumpet. There's no such thing.
My turn. Take a hike.
Duncan.
All right. Bye, Ruth. Thank you.
No, that was a good run.
Oh, you were going to switch it. That was pretty good.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Right. So do I stick with Duncan or do I pick a new guy?
Duncan's still in the mix.
All right, Duncan, what's my number? Better be 5.
5. Let's go 5.
It's always 5.
Stupid.
All right.
Orange. What do you got for me?
Aren't you glad he said 5, huh?
I know. Could just fuck with me.
What part of the drum kit did the Swiss company Pasty redesign for rock musicians?
Oh, easy. Cymbals.
I agree.
That's a piece of cake.
Got it.
You want me to read, Vic, so you can focus on your drops?
Yeah, sure.
All right, Duncan, give me another 5.
Yeah, I'm going to go with 5.
Stop it.
He's got 5 on the brain. Don't judge.
Was
yellow.
What color? Yellow? What movie heroine is... Eric and I used to do this thing back in when we lived together in Philly. We would do Trivial Pursuit and we'd read the questions so confusing. So what movie heroine is not king? Size. Her finger is ring. Size.
What? What
movie heroine is not, is not king size, her finger is ring size. It's like a lyric, I guess.
Her finger is ring size? What is this? Duncan, you gotta help me out, buddy.
Not king size. So it's like...
Queen?
One size?
What'd you say, Duncan?
One size? It's not king size.
I'm not reading the question again. Do you have a guess?
Small? Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Movie heroine. But it's a movie heroine. So
yeah, it's
got
a character from a movie.
Yeah.
I don't fucking know. Sally from Sally Met Harry Met Sally.
YouTube's going to flag this for reading Trivial Pursuit questions. These are copyrighted, right?
They should probably.
Yeah, I mean,
Sally, that's my answer.
It's close. It's Gidget.
Gidget.
One and out. Gidget. No advancement. Right.
Thanks for nothing, Duncan. Right, bye-bye.
Vic's turn.
Right, I'm up here.
Vic, you got to pick a...
Who do you want?
I need somebody to have to tell me a...
Someone has to pick your number. Okay. Oh, let's go to let's go to Lee and Aaron again. The crazy twins. One of them... Oh, did you have a shaved head?
The twins!
Yeah, the twins are back.
Oh, the twins.
Hey,
look at that crazy
haircut. Twins, pick a number. You know what? Your number's got to be 2.
Oh, yeah. We shaved it for quarantine, and it was a bad idea.
Twins, pick a number, quick.
7. No, 7 is too high.
2. They
four.
Put 2.
2, okay.
Oh,
2.
Wow.
That's fine.
It's always 5.
I'm still going to win.
No, they switched. They can't five. Switch. They, that, for, it's the first number that comes into your head.
It's five now.
That's how
five.
A dice works. You don't get to re-roll.
It should be four if they're twins because they would each have two. So four.
It's on two. Just play fair.
I tried, Vic.
The game's always five.
What? So what color is that? Purple?
Purple.
What 1930 Gershwin satire revolved around a Swiss-American war over chocolate?
Oh, man.
Not happening. Any guesses, twins?
No, nothing.
1930, did you say?
Yeah, 1930. It's a 1930 Gershwin satire.
Oh, this one sucks.
Shit.
I know, but
you're reading the answer. That's
I know. So that's, I mean, at some point you learn the answer.
There's like a chocolate shortage or something in this thing.
I bet I could give you three words of the answer and you still won't get it.
Go ahead.
No, I won't. I'll give you one word. I'll give you one word.
What's the question? Is it like the word?
Strike.
Oh, what was the name of the thing?
Chocolate strike. The chocolate strike. the chocolate strike.
It's strike up the band. Yellows.
Wow.
Strike up the band.
All right.
I should have known.
All right.
Who wants to give me a random number? Give me a random number.
You want to pick or you want me to pick? I'll just pick.
Okay.
Let's go with Jock Rebirth. Wait, what is that? Jock Rebirth.
Five.
Five.
Just, all right, five it is.
Surprise, surprise.
Always five.
Okay, I'm going to mute you, twins. Bye-bye. Good seeing you.
Zagreen.
Okay. What British new wave group takes its name from canine communication? These are the dumbest.
Bow, wow, wow.
Wow. Yep. Unfortunately, you are correct.
Amazing.
All right. I love your style, dude. Give me another one. Give me a five. What do you got? Five it is! Oh, I just ripped my... One, two, another five.
All right.
What do you got?
Wow. All right. This might be a tough one. Who painted the cover portrait for Bob Dylan's self-portrait album? Who painted the portrait? <Who's> the...
You think I don't know that?
Oh, man.
Why do you think that's a trick question?
I don't know. Who knows who paints the cover?
Bob Dylan did.
Correct. Sorry, I doubted.
It's called self-portrait.
Yeah.
So. Okay.
Oh, it's a little tricky.
Where's
right?
my I mean, boy? Where is he?
Why is he? No, he can talk, though. Why is he just holding up numbers? I lost him.
You can say hi.
Yeah.
Joel, give me a good one.
Where is he?
I need a, I need a hot five.
Here it comes. It's a five.
Yeah. By the way, we could roll a dice has
a
six.
Dice,
so
yeah,
we could do
could
six.
Could say six. But... Go to six. Yeah.
Well, all right, yellow. Who's Chuck Berry trying to call when he dials long distance information in Memphis, Texas?
Long distance information.
Texas.
In Memphis,
Tennessee.
Texas.
Memphis, Tennessee. Sorry, did I say Texas? Who's Chuck Berry trying to call when he dials long distance information?
Long distance operator. Memphis, Tennessee. I'm trying to. My baby.
Is that your final answer? Yeah. Incorrect. Marie.
Oh, man. All right. Let's do a deep dive at Chuck Berry. He's got sick past.
That's some fucked up shit.
Like all right. The toilet
me,
cameras
right?
and stuff like that. Yeah, like.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
I used to have a Chuck Berry drop.
Well, there was that great.
Fucking around.
You know what it
is? It was like, ooh, you can smell my farts.
Yeah. Oh, that's some awful. Sick shit.
Bad guy. Yeah.
Bad boy.
You know, did you read that article about James Brown? That came out a few. It was crazy.
I saw one at Rolling Stone about 12 years ago.
He like kidnapped this person.
No.
Oh, my
God.
He's a bad guy.
Jerry Lee, too. He's got a dark past. Jerry Lee Lewis.
All right.
Drove the Elvis' house one night and tried
Robbie,
to break
you'll,
in.
Robbie is an ally.
Robbie, and who's up, Vic?
Robbie and me, right? Yeah, we're going clockwise.
Yeah, you're up.
What?
Give me a number, Robbie, 1 to 5.
3.
What's up, Robbie? How you doing, buddy?
Good.
All right, Green, who's reading?
Green.
Son of a bitch.
What punk... Funkster philosophized For all of us, life is death without adventure.
What punk funk.
What punk funkster philosophizes. For all funkster. Of us, life is death without adventure.
Anthony Kiedis?
Prince.
Prince. Punk funkster.
Punk funkster. That doesn't suck.
This is no bullshit. Sense.
I don't know what to tell you.
Oh my God. That's,
I should have enlisted you, Robbie.
Should we mix up the we should get do the movie stuff the in? Movie one in?
Oh, I'm not going to get any of these.
Well, no. All right, well, let's play. Let's play. Let's play. Let's play. Sit down. Sit down.
Let's play out the music.
Maybe those could be like tiebreakers or something.
All right, Vic, pick your player. Pick your.
I'm going to go with Robbie. Robbie, give me a good one, please.
Oh, you're going to keep Robbie.
I'm going to keep Robbie.
All right. Back to you, Robbie.
Bye.
Oh,
man.
Okay.
I am kidding. When did I become the villain?
I know.
You're the suit, man. You're the boss.
Oh.
All right. You ready for what color?
I'm ready. What color? Am I red? I can't tell.
Yeah, red.
Orange or red. Whatever
right,
the hell you got.
Music theory here. How many beats does a quarter note get in 4/4 time?
Oh, come on.
One.
That's correct.
Ridiculous.
I'm getting it. All right. Ready? Roll. Robbie, you got another number for Vic?
Three.
Yellow.
And we can do six now. Is six an option now too?
Yeah, six is on the is on the table.
Okay.
All right. Listen to this. What Gene Vincent hit was inspired by comic book heroine Little Lulu?
Bebop-a-Lula.
Correct.
Wow.
Uh-oh. Someone's catching up.
Catching up.
All right, Robbie. Another number, please.
Four.
Four.
Am I on green or because you're on green, right?
I think so we can share.
Can we double up there?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Sure. Green. What avant-garde rocker was born Brian Peter George St. John de Baptiste Baptiste de La Salle Eno?
Well.
Oh.
Come on. Yeah,
I wish I had an Eno drop, but it's a Brian Eno I would have to go with.
Correct.
Bullshit. Oh, here's.
What? You take a break?
No, Brendan's here.
All right, bring him into the conversation.
I'm looking for him. Oh, there he is.
There he is.
All right, what's the next number, Robbie?
Isn't that? Wait, is
one.
That,
that's him.
One.
Right?
Oh, Robbie screwed you. He gave you a one.
A one? What the? All right. That's the last one you're getting, buddy.
All right. Go ahead. Move your board.
Red.
Red, okay. What? One? I can do it for you.
One, two, three.
What? Oh, here's another fucking Gershwin bullshit.
Oh, come on.
What 1933 Gershwin song focuses on painting the White House blue?
Oh.
Robbie, you know this
Robbie
one?
Robbie knows it. Paint the White
House. You can help. You're a full ally here.
Go, all if
right.
If you got it.
I think I got it.
Go for it.
Rhapsody in Blue.
Oh, Rhapsody in Blue.
No, it's not Rhapsody in Blue.
Wait. Do I have to go with that?
Yeah,
you do.
Okay, Rhapsody in Blue.
The answer is blue.
Blue. Oh, that was a good guess, though.
Good. Nice one, Robbie.
Rhapsody part in it.
I apologize for calling either of you idiots. It's not bad sportsmanship, okay?
Bye-bye, Robbie.
Thank you, Robbie.
Should we take a minute and have a chat with Brendon?
It's
Brendon?
A big inspiration
for
Brian.
Yeah,
what do you want, Brendon?
Rhapsody in Blue.
Wait, is he not Brendon?
That's him.
Yeah, that's him.
Brendon,
can you hear us?
Hello?
Yeah, there he is.
There he is.
Yeah.
What do you want?
I can hear you guys.
What's going on? We're trying to play a game here. What's up, man?
Yeah. I thought, is you playing for money?
Playing for money? No, we're playing because...
I thought this was like a poker thing.
No money involved in this.
We're playing
Trivial Pursuit.
Bart Knapp
on
just
Candy
woke
Land
up from his stupor to laugh at your little joke there. Your big hit.
Well, I don't see what's so funny. All right, $10. Ask me a question.
$10. All right. You want to go, asshole? I bet you $100. Yeah. And this is no joke. I'll bet you $100.
Okay.
What do the Dave Clark Five say over and over and over again?
Pass. Next
question. Can I steal this one from him?
Yeah, sure. Not for money, but
tonight's gonna be the night.
Nope.
No, it's that. It's like on the tip of my tongue.
Over and over and over right. again tonight.
Brendon, ready to go again?
All right.
She loves me.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
For $100, who was 17th century violin maker Niccolo Amati's greatest disciple?
Stradivarius.
So close. It's Antonio Stradivari.
Sorry,
buddy.
Wow. All right.
Stradivari.
Tough break.
Yeah, but you said Stradivarius.
No, I said Stradivari, yes. That's denoting correct, right?
All right, you won. Fine, you won $100 Monopoly dollars. All right, thank you, Brendon.
And I think we owe each other an apology for yesterday, Tim. Well, and I'll accept your apology, and you accept mine.
Yes, I apologize. On. I thought that you would have a good sense of humor about it. I thought you were going to be kind of roll with the punches.
I did.
You got very personal, and I apologize. Yep. I should have known better.
I apologize as well. I had, a pretty bad, incident with the car dealership that day. Uh-huh. So I was a little on edge.
All right. Well, why don't you get some rest, buddy?
Okay. What's?
You just have to hang up.
Tired.
You look tired.
Okay.
You look a mess. Sorry. You look. No offense. You look bad. Yeah. Thank you. All right. Is it still your turn, Vic?
Take care.
No, you're. You
no,
lost.
I lost the Gershwin. All right,
finally,
is
it's back
me.
To me, so I can sweep up. Who should I pick now? Who wants to be my partner? Who wants to give me nothing but fives?
Oh, you want some Luck of the Irish with Griffin Irish?
No.
No?
Let me see. I will be the one to judge. I did have good luck with
the
roof.
Jack,
but...
which is always
oh, yeah, get the jack. Jack. Yes.
That's a wall jack.
I'll get my drop ready.
Oh, I got my next guy picked. I know who I'm going to pick.
I'll bring in good old... I'll do the couple. We love couples. We love... Patrick Reynolds.
Can you unmute from there? Does it let you? No.
Mummy.
No.
Patrick Reynolds.
Go hunting. Just give me a number.
Oh, here, I got it.
Give me a number, Patrick.
I got you.
Five. Hey-o. Don't forget, folks, you can give six. All right.
Give me five,
that's
please.
Five.
Okay, purple.
Purple.
All right. What George M. Cohan classic claims... Every heart beats true under red, white, and blue.
Say that again?
What George M. Cohan classic
right.
claims every heart beats true under red, white, and blue.
How do you spell Cohan?
C-O-H-A-N.
Cohen.
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 Yeah.
Never a boaster brag.
You want to listen to this, Lifeline?
You coming in confident? Are you just randomly saying something?
Patrick?
Oh, sorry. I was trying to give you a hint. I can't hear over the music.
Oh, sorry. The grand old flag.
Sorry.
You're right. What? Well, say it again. Say it again.
The grand old flag.
Wrong. You're a grand old flag.
You're a grand. Oh, come on.
Hey, I play by the rules, Jack.
But read the question again.
Read the question. Answer.
Wait, what's your name
you
again?
Had the answer. You just had it slightly wrong.
What's your
wrong.
Name?
Patrick.
Oh, I thought this was Jack. Sorry. I was...
Pat. Yeah. Don't.
Sorry.
Well, okay, no. Fine.
Come on. That's okay. Now it's my turn. And I'm going to go with my buddy, Chris Robinson. Not Robinson, Robinson.
He's hey, what's up, Matt?
Hey, man. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. I loved your work today. Chris edited that very funny video today that we
cracked me up.
Release tomorrow because it's really funny.
Okay, what's your number?
Six.
Yeah, that's my buddy. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, green.
Okay. I'm just pulling this from the middle, by the way. What Elton John song claims, I quit those days in my redneck ways? Quickly.
Chris, help me out.
Quit those days in my redneck ways.
I oh. Jump. Honky Cat.
Yeah.
Thank you for the hint.
You're welcome.
That was gracious.
I'm a good person.
I thought you were just singing like a fake Elton John song. Just
jump to back, throw him off. Okay, Chris.
Another number, Chris. Honky-tonk. What's another number, Chris?
Between
1 and 6.
4.
Oh, boy.
Okay, yellow.
Whose induction into the Army cost the U.S. government $400,000 in taxes?
Elvis Presley?
Correct.
Oh, that's very good.
Another
very
number,
good.
Please.
Another
five.
Number.
Five?
That's purple. A true patriot, though, right there. I mean,
yeah. Seriously. And he paid taxes on his charitable contributions, too.
I was listening to an interview with John Lennon, and it was right after he came out of retirement, 1980. And he was saying, everyone was trying to ask me, you know, what did you think when Elvis died? And I wouldn't give him a quote. I'll give you the quote now. Elvis died when he went into the Army.
Oh. The fuck?
That's a good... What is the color?
Purple.
What Rodgers and Hammerstein show features Dietz Moi and Happy Talk?
Chris, you got anything? Rodgers and Hammerstein? Do you even know any Rodgers and Hammerstein?
Song, but I can't picture what it's from.
Rodgers and Hammerstein. Give my regards to Broadway.
I know what it is. Can I steal it?
Sure, why not?
Song of the South.
No, it's not Rodgers and Hammerstein.
who did Song of the South?
Thanks,
Disney.
Chris.
It was just a Disney movie.
Good seeing
you,
buddy.
It was a Broadway musical. It probably was the two guys that did all those Disney songs.
All right, Vic.
It's
the
South
Sherman
Pacific.
Brothers?
South Pacific. Vic, do you want to pick your person?
Isn't it my turn yet?
Who's on
Meg? You want to, or Sarah?
Sarah sounds good.
Sarah,
you're Vic.
Sarah.
I'm playing for Vic. Give him a number between 1 and 6.
Half of me. 4.
You could go 6 too, but this.
You got it.
1, 2, 3. I got blue.
Blue. Oh, am I asking?
Yeah, I'm pretty much disengaged.
All right. What's the parenthetical title of the Sounds of Sunshine's 71 hit Love Means?
Wait, parenthetical. Say it again.
So it's like, what's part of the, what's the rest of this title?
Love Means.
From this 1971 hit called Love Means.
Love Means.
These are worded so complicated.
I know the answer to this, though.
You want to steal? Oh, wait. Or Sarah, you got anything?
I don't.
I don't know.
Go ahead, Tim. You want to steal?
Love Means the World.
I don't want to steal. I just want to go. I just want to have my turn.
All right. It's you never
saving,
have to
yep, say goodbye.
Sorry. You never have to say you're sorry.
Yeah, it's one of those things.
One of those.
Never have to say I'm sorry.
Which way is?
Okay. Just put them in random. All right, who wants to read me a question? Who wants to be my... Actually, I'll stick with Sarah.
Can I show you my painting?
Yes.
Can you see it?
Oh, wow.
Look at that. Wow.
That's terrific.
Cool.
Good luck. Good luck to you.
Thanks.
What did you? Let me ask. Because you know what? Let me ask you this.
Hold it up again. I don't want you
to put you on the spot here.
I'm not
here.
Done.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
Are you doing that freehand, or are you tracing or something like that?
No, I'm freehand.
That is impressive. I see a lot of paintings, and sometimes I think, are you just like, is this a computer? A computer program?
Like they're coloring over the lines or whatever.
Yeah,
that's beautiful.
Doing it now.
So is that your hobby? Or are you studying painting? What's your interest in?
Just a hobby.
I wish I had a hobby like that, painting.
You can learn.
I don't think that's where my talents are.
It's hopeless.
So many talents. So, all right. Well, give me a number, Sarah. I'm like Dylan.
Sorry, I was a little late with that one.
6.
Big move, Sarah. Thank you.
4, 5, 6. Purple.
Purple. Purple boys, Tim and Eric. Pretty
what
cool.
is Frank Sinatra's middle name?
Oh.
Oh, I.
Sarah, you can help. Sarah, do you know?
I don't know it. I don't know.
Francis.
Leah and Aaron are trying to give hand signals.
Frank.
You could.
Vic could steal.
Sign language?
Steal essentially.
You know
Frank.
It,
you, it's,
I think I do, at least. Frank, my mind is not working tonight.
Francis, hold on. Let me. I have to check my. I forgot. I'm just checking your email. No, my wife is writing me about something. I just have to. See, what is the matter with you? I can't remember.
Vic, you want to steal?
It is Albert.
That's
Albert,
right. Yeah,
son of a bitch.
What happens with a steal?
We just move on. I just get the glory.
Just get this game going. Okay.
Thank you, Sarah. You know that, and thank you for the painting. Would you post that somewhere,
yes,
please?
Yes, it's beautiful.
When it's all
yeah,
done?
I'll post it when it's done.
Thank you so much.
Have a great weekend.
Francis Albert Sinatra.
I
know that.
I feel so stupid that I didn't know
that. That is very dumb. You should know. That's one of all the middle names to know.
I should be teaching that in schools.
It should be, right.
I'm going to try Griffin Irish.
But he did an album with...
see if he brings me luck.
Gilberto. Like
Mario
Kart Bossa Nova from 1966 or something. That's what it's called.
Oh, Francis. Oh, it's called Albert. Francis Sinatra. Albert Sinatra.
It's a great album, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, there's that great album of his that's like it's like this weird concept album.
Yeah, Watertown.
Watertown.
That is awesome. And it's written by Bob Gaudio, I think his name is, who wrote all the and produced all the Frankie Valli records.
Right.
And the songs, and a lot of the songs Watertown? Are by some like weird... some songwriter.
It's like a musical that never existed,
yeah,
or something.
It's very good. It's very good.
Watertown, Frank Sinatra.
Yeah. There's a song called Elizabeth that's really beautiful.
It's very weird. It's very dark.
Mm-hmm.
Check it out, everybody.
Yes.
It's got a weird cover, too. Good. It looks like the Yellow River Boys album cover, actually.
Really?
Yeah. It's like a
train. Oh, yeah, it does. It has that, like, that...
train...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Watertown. So it's a concept about...
Mm-hmm.
Like an old Jersey? Sleepy old. No, I think it's like a sleepy old. Oh, maybe. I don't really know.
I don't think it's a specific town. But every time I would drive through Watertown, New York, I'd put this on. Yeah.
All right. Who's up?
Me and Griffin. Give me a number, Griffin.
This is all right. This is a tough choice, but I think I'm. This is for Vic, right?
No, it's for me.
Oh, for Matt?
Yeah.
Oh, one is a good number.
It's a six, no doubt.
Oh, oh, everything. One, two,
family members calling up
five,
here.
Six. I knew Griffin would
when
be
I
good.
When I met with my pal Robert Davi. That was like when I tried to change the subject away from
politics.
I said, "You ever listen to Watertown?" And then I talked to him. No, he's like, "Oh yeah, I know that one." And then, but then on Fox News, like he could not get it off his mind. And
drag
what was
right
it like working
in
with Corey Feldman?
Yeah.
All right.
Purple for me.
Purple Boys, Tim and Eric. What rotund big band blues shouter was dubbed Mr. 5x5? Everybody knows this one.
Yes.
Solomon Burke?
Ooh, that's a good guess. But...
No, Jimmy Rushing.
Come on. Of course.
Yeah, Jimmy Rushing.
Jimmy Rushing.
Jimmy Rushing or
Jimmy
Russian?
Rushing. Yeah,
oh,
Jimmy
I didn't
Rushing.
Even check in
Everyone
with Griffin.
Knows that.
Oh. I thought it was from the Rush. Temptations.
Sorry about that, Griffin.
I didn't even... Did you know it, Griffin?
Okay. Griffin, what's another number for... Do I go? Am I up now?
It's your turn, Vic.
All right, pick a number.
Well, if it's... I mean, if it's Vic, it's got to be a six as well.
Wow.
Thank you.
Are you an anti-Tim?
That's what's
Is that
going
what you
on
are?
Here.
One, two, three, four, five,
That's
six.
The vibe I'm getting, Griffin.
I like this guy.
If it was me, he'd been doing one, I know.
I work behind the scenes, so I know how it feels. So.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There would be no scenes without me to work behind. How about that?
All right. Vic, what do you got? Blue?
Yep.
Okay. What group recorded its first and last British albums in London's Abbey Road studio?
I feel like it's going to be a tricky one, though. Like, I mean, obviously...
Watch him squirm.
Oh, you're right.
Right?
Yeah.
It must be.
Must be. Must be.
The Monk? No, I'm going to go with the Beatles.
You're correct.
I was thinking it'd be like a little...
We could have fucked with him bad.
No, really, I was about to fall for him. Pretty,
they did Please Please Me in Abbey Road. They did Abbey Road in Abbey Road.
Right, they did Abbey Road in Abbey Road.
All right, although, Griffin, give him another number.
But I mean, I Want You probably... She's So Heavy might have been done in Trident Studios.
Oh, really? Well, then...
For Vic.
Yeah, okay.
What do you got?
I mean, it's got to be a 6.
Oh!
Wow, thank you.
Blue. Okay.
Is this better or worse than video games? Can anyone chime in on that?
Oh, it's way better.
Oh, there we go.
Good
like
answer.
To hear that. Even if it's not answer. True, we like to hear that.
That is the correct answer.
How about I can just... I'm shooting at the Candyland board. Have you shown the board in a while?
Yeah, let's
Wes?
See the board. Let's see the how we're...
Oh, yeah, he's
on. Okay, so this is, I guess this is Tim, right? And this is me? I don't even know.
Or no, you're red.
I'm red. I'm behind.
I moved you.
Okay.
I got you to blue. Okay. So we're staying with Frank. What Frank Sinatra LP announces past, present, future? Announces.
This is past like a is like a 70s Sinatra record if I'm not
sure.
What is it? Announces past, present.
Frank Cum Sinatra, someone in the chat says.
But can you just read it again one more time?
What Frank, I'll make it easy. What Frank Sinatra LP is named has past, present, and past, present, future in the name? Announces. It's such a goofball way to say it.
Past, present, future, greatest hits. I don't know. What does that mean?
Should we see if you're, but Griffin, you know?
Can't think of it.
Griffin saved your ass.
What did he say?
Trilogy, correct.
Trilogy, all right. Thank you.
Give him a number.
This is too confusing to me.
What's your number, Griffin?
For Vic again?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. This is hard. 6, I guess.
All right.
5, 6. Blue again.
Believe me, I'm still ahead.
Not by much.
Enough.
How many cuts graced the Clash's 3-disc set Sandinista? 26, 31, or 36? How many tracks are on Sandinista by the Clash?
So it's 26, 31, 36. I would assume it's... Was it a triple album? Or was it a double album?
It says 3-disc, 3-disc.
3-disc, 3-vinyl.
Yeah.
Vic thinks that sound comes out of the bottom of his chin. Where his mic is.
Well, I don't know. It's hard to... All right, I'm going to go... ...36.
Correct.
All right.
That's the longest drum roll in the history of...
Right. You're sticking with Griffin with your numbers?
Yeah, thank you, Griffin. What do you got for me? Hopefully it's something over 5.
Well, I'm hoping Vic goes all the way, so I'm going to go with 6, actually, again.
Thank you. This is nuts.
Pink. What ditty opens? You put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. Come on.
It's got to be, the Hokey Pokey? Yeah, I would hope so. All right.
Obviously. Keep going, Griffin.
Right.
What'd you say?
Wait. You sorry. The drum roll's about to end.
It's obviously 6. So.
6. I'll take it.
We gotta start looking at rules. Yeah. About how many 6s you can
yellow okay.
get?
Yellow.
Yellow. Oh, wait. You already read that.
That's Doug's drop. I need that one.
Yellow. Yellow. I could just do it. Yellow. Yellow.
Yellow. Oh, yellow. What Gene Vincent? What Gene Vincent hit was inspired by comic book heroine Little Lou?
Wait, we did that. Did that?
What are the chances?
Oh, yeah.
I'm just putting them in randomly. Yeah. Chances are good.
Chances are good.
This microphone thing.
What trumpeter hit with Sugarfoot Stomp and Satchel Mouth Swing?
Oh. I mean, it's got to be Louis Armstrong.
Correct. Griff.
Thank you, Griffin.
Matchmo?
Yeah. What do you got? How many? What's his number? 6 again.
Oh, no.
I'm really pulling ahead here.
Oh,
kind
and is it
going to
keep giving yellow? That's. No. This makes
I guess I should know. No more strategy.
Right. Oh, is it just like Every six is a yellow.
Maybe. Right? What soul king noted of his youth? I was so poor, my underwear was made out of flour sacks.
A soul king?
Yeah, soul king.
So, I mean, it could be like Otis Redding. It could be a Wilson Pickett. It could be a James Brown. That sounds like a James Brown to me.
Correct. Let me guess, Griffin, six. And yellow again.
You want to change it up a little bit?
Let's do five.
Okay. There we go. There we go. Get me off the yellow.
Yeah, just because I'm, you know, I don't want to.
Yeah.
I'm going to just start watching a Tim Pool live stream. I mean.
How do people watch these video game shows? It seems even more boring than this. What eye ailment did Ray Charles contract in childhood leading to his blindness?
Are you scrolling through all the eye ailments you know?
No, too many. It was something with an L in it.
Time's up.
Wait till the song ends. It was God damn it. I don't know. I don't know.
Griffin?
Is it glaucoma?
Correct.
What?
Wow.
Glaucoma?
It's really? The only thing I know. It's the only eye ailment I know.
Only eye disease I can think
of. Yeah.
So
all right. Do we have to cut it off at a time? Because like this is like I'm on a roll here. I'm just like win, but
go.
All right.
What's your number, Griff?
Pick another number.
Let's do six.
All right. here. Hopefully you won't get this. What Broadway star was California Here I Come written for?
Broadway star, California. I'm going to say Ethel Merman.
Incorrect. Al Jolson.
Yeah, it's Al Jolson.
All right. Oh, I love him. He's
Al Jolson.
Yeah. One of the greats.
One of the blackface guys. I love him.
All right. I say we mix up, we introduce the movie cards.
What you do
say?
That?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, bring the movie cards for my role. This microphone, how does Doug deal with this? It's a disaster. It's all coming apart.
It is like wearing someone else's underpants, switching seats, you know?
Okay, ready? Give me somebody good. Give me somebody good. Who wants it? Who wants to get in the game? Who believes in it? Oh, I got Logan playing that saxophone. And
where's Logan?
Logan with the Steve Brule. He's got a piano. He's got everything tonight. He has got... Sorry, Charlie Patton with the cowboy hat and your girlfriend shaking her butt.
I see you.
He's right there, man. You see him right there, don't you?
Oh, at a piano. Okay. Shit.
You can't open the box.
That's so hard to
open. All right, Logan, give me a number, son.
I still can't find him. What the fuck?
Just give me a number. Six! Woohoo! Lordy, lordy. We are in business. Six. Purple me.
Oh, here's Logan. I got you. Okay.
Purple, what are you playing anyway?
Oh, nice.
Whoa, what's in that?
Oh.
Hey, I did that remix for you.
Let's take it from the top because we didn't hear the beginning of it. Oh, one, okay. Two, three, four! I like people who can make me laugh. I like having fun. I like to smile. I like people who can make me smile. All right, Logan. Wow. You gave me the magic number of six.
Wait, what was the remix that you did? What was you said?
Oh, I did a remix of the sax solo. You know, the I like to laugh, I like to have fun.
Oh, awesome, man.
You're reading? You're reading. Or do you want to do drops? You want me to read?
I'll read this one just to start it out.
Some trivia, though.
Which one?
These are movies now, folks. We've switched it up.
Purple, you
Purple.
Said? Okay. What film featured the characters Sally Bowles, Natalia Launderer, and Christopher Isherwood? Isherwood.
What?
Whew, might be before my time.
Yeah. What film featured the characters Sally Bowles?
Sally Bowles.
Bowles. Natalia Landauer and Christopher Isherwood.
Sally Bowles sounds familiar. She's like something to do with King Henry VIII.
Sure.
It's ringing no bells for me.
No bells rung.
Is it A Man for All Seasons?
Is that your final answer?
No. It's, is it Sally Bowles? Is it, I know what it is. It's the Jack the Ripper.
Is I Am a Camera.
I Am a Camera. Yeah, the, no, that's what I mean. I'm a camera.
That's what you, I like that this card. Also, another answer is I Am a Camera.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There's a lot of those.
Never heard of no
James Brown card. I had like five James Brown answers.
What? Well,
that's a shame that that happens.
That's how it goes.
It was a fun call with, what's his name again?
All right, Logan. Thank you.
For nothing. Bad Logan.
Luck. Good tune, Smith, but bad luck.
Yes. Play yourself out. Great.
All right, what do you got? Matt.
Turn. Oh, it's me. Oh, shit. Meg. Meg looks smart.
Meg, give us a number.
Don't fail me.
Six.
Yes.
Nice.
No contrarians in this group.
Yellow.
Yellow.
It doesn't. Yeah, it would make for more interesting.
Okay. Oh, you're going to know this one.
Nice.
What composer-arranger caused a stir at the 1974 Academy Awards by becoming the first person to win three Oscars in a night?
Composer?
Yeah. Composer arrangers.
In what year?
74.
Meg, you have any thoughts on this?
War.
I mean, my first reaction is Burt Bacharach.
That would be a good guess.
Burt Bacharach.
And it would be wrong.
Ah,
Henry Mancini?
Shit.
Marvin Hamlisch.
Oh, Hamlisch.
Why did you say he would know that?
Just to throw him off. I'm getting
Thanks,
in.
Meg.
I told him very competitive.
We did our best.
All right, then.
Oh, did you have anything else to say? I muted you.
That's Vicky's
okay,
turn.
Meg, where are you calling it from tonight?
I'm in Michigan.
Nice. What's going on in Michigan tonight? Are there... what do you call them? Never mind.
All right, let's take a break and listen and take some of your questions.
Oh, that's a good idea.
How about Charlie Patton?
Oh, yeah, I saw Charlie in there. He has a cool look, but where'd he go?
We see it, Charlie. Matt's just tracking you down.
Shit.
I'm trying to find my Michigan drops. That's what was on my
Charlie!
Mind. I thought I had some.
Charlie. This... Oh, there he is. There's Charlie.
Hello, Charlie.
Hello. How are you?
Good. How can I help you tonight?
Well, I'm a huge huge fan. Hello, Vic. Hello,
hey,
Matt.
Charlie.
Is your fandom, is your appreciation of me diminishing at all tonight? Or is
answer.
You'd be like, oh, no, no. I am a huge fan. I've been watching you since... well, for quite a while. But here's the thing. Okay, so I have like...
Here's the thing.
one more minute. One more minute. Just allow me one more minute now. Oh, you were affiliate. I'm going to throw it on you. I hope I'm not attacking you. But I love you. Okay. But you were a Phillies fan. Okay. And then you came out to Los Angeles and then... I'm a Dodger fan, so like...
Yeah. Well, listen, I'll talk about that. I'll address that. That's not something I'm ashamed of.
Brisky, you need one?
Here's the deal.
Yeah, I'll take one.
The Phillies broke my heart.
How's that?
It was the... I mean, listen, I was with them and all the way through... I don't know what the... I can't remember any years, but 2009 maybe they won the World Series. 2008.
Yeah.
I was with them every day, every game. Every game when I'm living in L.A. But I also was watching the Dodgers, and I'd go to Dodgers games because I live here. And, you know, eventually I've been... I mean, I'm here like 13 years now. So I just... Listen, I like going to the games, and the games are on the TV. And my kids are growing up here, man. So... I can take them to the games, and I want them to, like, wear a Dodgers jersey at the game. Right. I don't want them going to the game dressed in Phillies gear and getting like weird
beers
looks.
Thrown at them.
Do you get that, Charlie?
Here's.
You're talking, but we can't hear you. And maybe that's a good thing.
But isn't there like a heritage thing? Like,
no, I don't believe in any of that. It's first of all these.
But so it's just like, and this is what I'm trying to make a point of is like assimilating. Is there's like a assimilation into mm-hmm. a new society, and so you have moved from Philadelphia, into Los Angeles, and you. Now, taking like I'm a Cleveland fan because my dad's from Cleveland. I'm from Arizona. I live in Los Angeles. I could give a shit about the Dodgers. I could give a shit about the Diamondbacks.
Easy.
But, now listen.
Uh-oh. Kind of.
I also, I'll be honest. I'm a fair weather fan. I like good teams, and the Dodgers have had a really fun, exciting, great team the past few years. They've got terrific players. They win games. They're champions.
Baseball games, football Although games, basketball blown it. Games, ice hockey games.
I don't know.
Games.
Listen, Charlie. I don't know what's going on with your sound. You keep
second.
Keeps muting. There we go.
But if it's between the Dodgers and the Phillies, I would root for the Phillies if they were in the World Series, of course. Okay, right. We have to move on.
What's the name of the pup that you got there? What's your pup's
get out.
Name?
Who
Come
cares?
On.
Listen, it's
next.
Dog's name is fucking.
I want to know.
He had a say.
Charlie Wait a minute. What's going say. On with my brain? I can't think of like the most basic name of a dog.
Rufus.
Rufus.
Fifi. No.
Bowser.
No.
Bow Wow. Or,
no.
Fucking Fred.
Fido. Thank
Fido.
You.
Fido.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks, Charlie. It is a cute dog.
It's a great dog. All right. It's my turn, right?
Oh, we're playing. Are we still playing? Yeah. Oh, wait. Is Charlie going to give your number?
Are we doing it? Yeah, we're doing another.
Actually, it's Vic's turn. I was almost going to cheat. But...
Did I get an answer right? Or
no? Oh, how about the On Cinema Painter? Where Brian? Is that your work?
Where are you?
Brian Benelli, right here. See?
Oh, okay. All right. Man, it really...
It's a bummer that we can't.
You can't just control it. I don't know why your laptop didn't work.
I guess I could just do sound out of this and switch it out.
See you, man.
He's bye, Charlie. Bye. Go Indians, you know? Why'd you change the name of your team, man? Cleveland that. Indians? There's That's that. Sick, calling them the Indians.
Dude, I just can't fucking blame this guy.
Well, just give me somebody. I don't care. Sorry, I don't, you know, it's not my problem. I mean, it's not my choice. I would love to have you on the show.
What was his name? Let's talk to Shaq T.
Shaq, give me a number.
He's got some
Wait,
wild.
No, it's Vic's, going, guys? It's Vic's
I think,
turn. Anyway.
I think I got it one wrong, though, didn't I? What was it about?
Who thinks it's Vic's turn?
Yeah.
Who's keeping track? It's Vic's turn, yeah.
I think I...
No, you haven't answered a movie question yet.
Oh, yeah, okay.
All okay.
Right. Should I read it to myself?
Oh, I'll read it. Sorry.
What's your number?
I can do it.
Oh, you got to get
okay,
your number.
I'm going with three.
Three, okay.
Three. Ouch. Wait, oh, you're right. He's in the lead, too. One, two, three. Orange. Okay.
One, two, three.
Who portrayed the doomed Dr. Schumann in Ship of Fools? That's...
Oh, boy.
Suck.
Ship of Dr. Schumann.
Ship of Fools.
You want to call Greg Turkington?
Yeah, he would know this one. But this is like... I would guess it's like 50s.
Obscure.
Ship of.
You're never. I mean, you're never gonna get it. This is just preposterous.
No, I give up.
Oscar Werner.
Yeah.
Sure.
I would never have gotten that.
I guess that is the with the picking six all the time or whatever. You never know. It could be a hard question.
Right. Somebody give me six. Give me somebody, Matt.
Matt Van Dam wants to give you six. But I gotta find the. Where are you? Green? One, two, three. Four, five, six, seven. Oh, right. So it's gonna keep being purple for a while. What 1944 Otto Preminger film was about the alleged murder of career girl Laura Hunt?
What the fuck is this?
That? Yeah, this is. I almost
well,
left the video.
Well, okay,
the
though. You might
movie
get
ones
it.
At home because they're so ridiculous.
Otto Preminger about the career girl Laura Hunt.
Oh,
Oh?
No.
I think I got
it. Suck.
Hunt the whore.
No.
Hunt the whore.
Now I lost.
Was there a remake of it later in the 90s?
Matt, you have an answer?
Hey, how's it going? Is it Anatomy of a Murder?
No. Ooh. It's Laura. Because it's about Laura.
Laura.
Oh, this stupid. Yeah. Hey, also, Tokai Madden, he's awesome.
Okay,
he's
Guy
amazing.
Madden,
and he's made so many more films.
Thank you.
Nice.
Thank you. I'll take credit for his work. All right. I don't know about these movie questions.
This is probably
so
a bad idea.
Obscure.
All right. Maybe we should wrap things up.
It has been almost 2 hours.
Do we want to just when we end on some calls and some chats and some news of the day?
Who has a good question? No fucking around.
How about a question for Vic, since I have to urinate quite badly?
Oh, there you go. Oh, Mike D, you have something for Vic? Yeah? All right. Unmute. You got to unmute on your side.
There we go.
How's that, buddy?
Hey, what's going on, guys?
What's up, Mike?
What's up, man? I got to ask Vic, now that the COVID and pandemic is happening, how horrible is it going to be that potentially the only people that survived this are people that bought Jim Baker's stupid buckets?
Yeah, I mean, seriously, that is like something that, you know, my dad, I was making fun of my dad for a good 3-4 months before all this shit happened. And he's like, you know, hearing rumblings about it. He's like, it's going to be a food shortage and all this stuff. And he stocked up on rice and he would send me pictures of his stockpile. And he would text it to me. I'd immediately send it to all my friends. Like, look at this goofball my dad is. And then it happened. It all happened and it all came real. And now he's the one laughing with all the rice and Twinkies that he stocked up on and
pea soup.
But my dad didn't do very good with it because he sent me a picture and I looked at it and there were two massive boxes of Equal, like, you know, that you put in. Like, it's like Splenda kind of thing. Like, what are you going to do with that much? How are you going to survive, you know, on that? But
cruel joke.
Yeah. But I don't know. It's crazy. It worked out for Jim.
Well, there you go.
With Jim, yeah. Well, maybe it didn't work out. He just had a stroke, too. So maybe it didn't work out for him, the poor guy.
Well, yeah. Karma's a bitch.
Yeah, seriously. Where are you calling from, Mike?
I'm outside of Raleigh, North Carolina, so.
Ah, okay.
Originally from New England. We moved down here recently, so.
Nice.
Yeah.
You like it down there? You close to the water?
Got some little ASMR for you guys.
No, we're a few hours out. I miss the ocean. We were from the seacoast, New Hampshire, so we really miss the ocean.
Oh, wow.
Good. That's Doug's not cool, here, man. So we don't get a... pickle drops, but we do get popcorn drops tonight.
Oh, sounds sexy.
Yeah, doesn't that sound good?
All right, give me
somebody. So do I just kind of...
Someone messaged with...
Thanks,
guys.
Talk to
another couple. Take care, buddy.
Carrie Fessenmeyer.
Hello?
Carrie Fessenmeyer. You have to unmute on your side. You're on the air.
You're on the air.
Patriots only.
How can I help you? Where's my mic?
Did it cut out?
Hello?
Where's
my
Carrie?
Line?
Got her entrance music.
All right. Did that not work? What happened?
Move on.
All right. Sorry, Carrie. It's not working on your side.
Something happened to my mic. Something weird happened.
Shit.
Oh.
Hey.
Oh, wait. Oh, are you there, Carrie?
Hello.
No, I muted you again.
Okay.
Can you unmute?
It's kind of weird. Hello.
Oh, there you are.
One, two, three!
Fucking bona fide moron.
You're so well known for having problems with audio.
What's up? Can I help you?
Is the game over?
The game's on. We're suspended. YouTube has a copyright claim on Trivia Pursuit knowledge.
That's really rude. Yeah.
You got a question or something?
The Candyland art.
Yeah, what do you want to talk about? You've got my attention. You can ask me anything you want in the whole world.
Oh, I see someone else.
Saturday.
All right, you don't have anything to say. Flick.
No, wait, no.
Flick's down under. And we've been trying to get to Flick because you're like on social,
Flick,
right?
From A Christmas Story.
Oh, yeah.
All right, say something, Flick.
Yeah, that's me.
All right. Do I have to unmute myself?
There you go. No, you're good.
Okay, cool. Hey, guys.
Hello.
Hi, Tim. How you going? Vic and hey. Matt.
Where are you from? Yeah, I got my drops ready because I hear the accent. Where are you from?
Yeah, well, I'm from Adelaide, which is right down the
yeah. Did you see Tim and Eric in Adelaide?
Yeah, I came to the show. It was sensational.
You ever hear the Ben Folds song, Adelaide? I'm so excited about that. I love that song.
That's a great song. Yeah, he lived here for a while. I guess.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. Go ahead.
That's all good. Yeah, I love the show. And I don't know if you remember, Tim, but after the show, you came out on stage with your guitar, just like strumming.
Yeah.
And people were coming up to say hi. And then we attempted a version of Hey Jude.
Yeah. I do remember that because.
Which was pretty, like neither of us really knew how to play it.
I could play. I mean, I could play it. But
no. What is? But then everyone was
hey
singing along.
Jude, oh, I think it's
yeah, let's do it.
Don't be afraid. Take a sad song. No, you know what's funny about that was anybody that was at the Tim and Eric live show earlier this year before the end times began.
Yeah, Brian Wilson. Yeah, that was one of the last shows I saw. Jude.
No, but. We played. This is a cool way to hold my guitar. I'm like this. So I started working with Kenny Brown. When I started recording with Kenny Brown.
Oh, my phone's not working.
I started writing songs with Kenny Brown. He's the unbelievable producer, and the whole experience of recording with him is so beautiful because you come in with like a whole mess of songs. And he kind of roots through them, and you find like there's actually a commonality in where you come from. And a lot of the songs I write are actually coming from inside. You know, they're coming from a place of true, you know, like my mama was spiritual, and she always used to tell me that there's a lot of heart in your music, you know, and I understand that. So when Kenny Brown sat me down and said, I want to hear what you've been working on, you know, When he heard Don't Cry for an Angel, he said, damn, son, that's the finest song I ever heard. And he sat there and cried. So
hashtag happy.
We recorded that with Dwayne Wayne Shepherd. We recorded that with Dwayne Wayne Shepherd, Thomas Howell, Bertie Ettram, Scooter Malloy. And it came out, and it was like... Oh, it just shot up the charts. I mean, it was like, that's all you could hear on the radio was Don't Cry for an Angel. And, you know, that's just changed my life. Like within a second, the second that song came out, it changed everything. And I went from, I was living in a hole. I had a hole dug out that I was going to bury myself in. Someone was trying to kill me. And I was been poisoned. And then that song had come out, and I remember the second it came out, I changed my life forever, and I became the richest man in the world, and I appeared on Tonight Show. And that's because all music comes from the heart, and that's what Kenny Brown knew.
Why was the guy trying to kill you, Tim?
Because I mean, killed his wife.
Kenny.
Kenny Brown's just my... I'm doing an interview for a documentary about Kenny Brown. Okay. He's a legendary. Kenny Brown's a legendary producer. You see,
right.
And I'm so Scott Shepherd.
Oh, Scott.
I'm Scott right. Shepherd. Okay. And I had the song number one hit, "Don't Cry for an Angel," in 1997.
So you killed this guy's wife?
I killed his wife. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
How did I kill his wife?
Yeah,
I was drunk driving and I ran her down.
Fuck. Okay, that sucks.
But everything changed, man. Like as soon as we went number one on the Billboard country music charts, and then we actually went number one on the Hot 100 international world music charts as well. And I remember Kenny Wayne Shepherd called me, and Bob Dole called me. Bob Dole asked me to run for vice president. He wanted me to be vice president for Bob Dole. Don't cry an angel. That's all there is to know. Angel gonna cry for someone else, don't you? I remember Adelaide because if people were at our shows in the United States and in most other places, they were big theaters, 1,000, 2,000 seat, like legitimate theaters. And the one place it wasn't was Adelaide, which was like a rock club, like a small.
So the Gov.
Yeah, a small rock club with a very small stage. And so we were like, we had to do this show that we would normally do on a on a much bigger stage there. Yeah. And so it was a very intimate show. And I definitely felt like after that show, I was all about going out and hanging out with the, you know, you guys out there. And I, you know, there's nothing else to do. What else am I going to do in Adelaide?
Totally. But there's a bit of a, like, there's a good music scene and stuff down here. I don't know if you're ever going to make it back here.
I think it was at, you know? It must have been in Adelaide. The night, we got in the night before and we went to a random bar and there was a really good rock band, but they were like high schoolers. And they're, like, it was just us and their parents and their friends.
Oh my God.
At this, like, it was like 20 of us. And they were fucking good. Like, they were like the psych rock, like heavy. Right. Sounded kind of like the Doors.
One of them have a really big afro?
Maybe.
Because this shows how small Adelaide is. I reckon, anyway, I don't know. Vicious Pandas. I've got some students who are in this band, Vicious Pandas, and they're teenagers. And
we'll have to find
crazy.
Out who they were. I wonder if. Yeah, I could find out who they were. Probably.
Yeah.
All right.
But,
nice to talk to you.
Really
all
nice
the best.
Okay, thank you so much. See you guys.
Bye, Flick.
All right, let's take a couple more.
Okay. Okay, Burf Sternberg. Burf. You're on, Burf. You look like a shredder.
You're on.
This is your chance, kid. Don't blow it.
Skip this game. It's boring. It's nothing. I hate it. Also, Vic didn't show into work today.
Doug.
Sorry. I always get those two mixed up.
Well, what are you, 12?
What the heck?
Wait a minute.
So I'm his replacement.
Whoa, Doug is done.
All right, let's back up. You came in hot. What's your, who is this?
I even have drops.
He's even got his own drops. Wow, let's go back and
wait a minute.
Hold on, is that a horse I heard? Hold on.
Drop.
What up?
I challenge you to rock, paper, scissors, but not anybody else, just Vic.
Okay, let's do it.
He's coming at you, Vic.
Ready?
One,
you have to look here. Two, three, go. Scissors. What do you got?
Paper? Scissors.
All right, like let's do it again. One. Two, three.
Scissors.
Wait a minute. I got to talk to you. Who are you? What's your name? Identify yourself, goddammit.
Yeah. My father has been doing these very...
Hi, Emily Romano.
Get out of here!
That's your dad?
Yeah.
What did he say? His name was Ray Romano?
How old are you, son?
I'm Ray Romano. I've been on here before. Ow, my son.
Wait, is it really Ray Romano?
Why don't you get your son in line here? This is insane.
It's very late, too. Shouldn't he be in bed?
Wait a minute. Did you have your son when you were 12? What does? You guys look like you're the same age.
Oh, yeah. You want to hear the truth about the Freemasons?
Yes. Of course I do, son.
From their basement.
All right. Well, I want to get to some basic information here.
Where'd he go?
Oh, the deep state. Deep state knocked him off.
Oh, no, there he is. Oh, there he is. There he is.
Okay.
All right. How old are you, boy?
11.
Was that a guitar?
Yeah.
You play?
No. My dad just made me hold it so that I'll get on.
Where are you calling from? How late are you up?
I'm calling from Guelph.
Ontario, yeah.
I'm talking to Canadians. Get out. Right. Hey.
We didn't give up.
Huh?
We didn't give up.
We did not get up.
Give up.
How
give
close up. Are you, how close are you to Charbert Lake? Do you know Charbert Lake at all?
I do not.
It's in Ontario. I have a family member who has a place there.
Gazing well. Ontario.
So listen,
which
kid.
Is very far up north. It's it's like.
So kid, stop this. I'm not interested in where everything is.
Near Kingston, where I go.
Everything is close to something else. Do you understand how that works?
Trying to, you know.
Nepal is near.
Right.
Some other just part
trying
of
to shift
India.
The story away from the kid being up so late. You know,
don't just mind him.
Listen, what are you doing, Dad? Just hanging out with your boy on a Friday night?
That's what we're doing.
This I love
is,
it.
It's me and my boy. And
I dream of that.
Yeah.
A better time.
He was a big fan of Awesome Show, and I was raised with it.
So you've seen all this stuff, huh, kid?
Yes. I think I might have been scarred.
I bet. But you're not into this. You're not into the trivia game? Are you not happy with the show we're doing tonight?
Boring.
It is boring. Yeah, I hate it.
No, he's had a tough time with the trivia game, but
well, maybe you should be. Maybe you're learning. How about that?
Hey.
Yeah, I mean, learning is good. What do you think, Jack?
It's summer vacation.
His name is Jack.
Yeah, Jack. The Indian. All
right, you guys have made my week.
Thank you. Wonderful.
Kind of buried the lead with his name is Jack.
I know.
No, really.
All right. How about Alexis?
That was awesome.
Thanks, Jack and Dad.
Keep going with the drops. One day you'll make it.
Where's Alexis? This is so difficult.
Who?
Where?
Alexis waved. She's got tattoos.
Wave your arms around. Wave your arms.
Everybody has tattoos except me and Vic and Matt and everybody else I know.
Nice clean mind and a
clean
body.
How many screens are there?
I have six.
Oh, dear.
And it's... Wait, six what?
Oh, so if you're just hanging out on one of the screens, I just need to figure out which screen it is. I mean, this is what Vic doesn't know
lot.
What I'm dealing
it's,
with
it's
here.
It's so stressful.
It's very confusing.
Alexis, can you wave vigorously? Yeah.
Oh, wait, go back. There she is.
Hi, Alexis.
She
I got
like
you.
Muted, too.
You got to unmute on your side.
Hello, Alexis.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Not that unbelievable.
Hello.
Yeah, you hear me?
Yes.
Sephahide.
Sephahide. Wow. Okay. Yeah. I'm new to the show. I've been a long time fan of Tim and your work.
Thank you.
Now what can I do?
My boyfriend hates you.
Why?
For some reason. So I have to kind of. He thinks that you're too cynical, and I've showed him certain things, and I was like, okay.
What is the problem?
Yeah.
What? Let's talk to him. Get him on the.
I don't
get him on the horn.
Me.
I have.
Wait, wake him up.
Where is cynical as Tim Pool?
Get in
and
here.
All these other rats that are all. I'm full of positivity. I like having fun. I like to laugh.
I know, Tim. I know.
I mean, I have a dark view of the world, I guess, you know, through the, if you look at my work.
Well,
but.
he's a happy-go-lucky, free spirit. Most people think that he's such an open-minded person, but I'm like, how can you think that?
He's a Dead fan. Code for.
Is he a Grateful Dead fan?
Oh, no. Well, a bit. Mm, but that's he's walking my dog right now.
Wow. Sounds like he got him tied up on a short leash, huh?
Yeah. I do a bit. Yeah.
Well, good for you. I mean, this guy sounds like a real lowlife. Like, I mean, honestly, he sounds like a bad guy. His terrible taste if he's not into my scene. Right? I mean, this is a bad guy.
He's actually really funny, and I couldn't believe that he didn't like you.
Well, what does he mean? He doesn't like anything. Like, he doesn't like Tim and Eric. He doesn't like On Cinema. He doesn't like Bridesmaids. Or is he not?
So I was showing him that video that you did, the little chub video. I got a chub for you.
Sure.
Big fat chub for you. Yeah. All kinds of things I showed him. He was like, no, this is this is not good.
Does he know you're Zooming with me right now?
Yeah, well, he does, yeah. And he thinks I'm stupid for doing it.
This is, you know what? How long have you been with this clown?
Why the fuck? 5 years.
Oh, yeah. But oh, yeah.
Drop that zero and deal with the
I mean, this guy must be a good-looking guy because otherwise, what's there to I don't get it.
Well, yeah, you know, he's 15 years older than me.
This gets worse and worse.
This is sick.
We're from different generational. You know, there's gaps.
That's quite a quite an age gap. Yeah. But I mean, how old are you?
Like? What does he
Wait
like?
A minute, we might have a criminal situation. <on our hands. laughs> How old are you?
I'm 30, and he's
some straight up pedophile crap.
So you got together with him when you were 25, and he was 40.
Yes. Yeah.
What do you guys talk about?
We don't have a whole lot in common in terms of like pop culture kind of stuff. I actually got him to read Harry Potter, which was a huge win. For me, because he actually liked it a lot. I don't know if you're a fan of Harry Potter, but
no, I tried to watch the movie with my kids, and I got very confused. I got lost. I don't know what's going on. You know what I don't understand about Harry Potter. Here, folks. Here's what I don't get about Harry Potter. I couldn't sense any real, like, good or bad guys in that movie. It was just like a bunch of wizards.
Right.
Well, if it's the movies you watch, then there's your problem. You got to read the books.
I'm reading Charlie Kaufman. I'm reading big stuff. By the way, I lost it because I looked on the AV Club, and some louse there reviewed the Charlie Kaufman book that I love. Gave it a C-. And he was like, "This book is pretentious and his fall up all up his own ass." And I send it to Megan Keister, our friend on the show. Because she loved the book. And she's like, "Well, look at this. The guy that reviewed this book also reviewed like this Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Like he's reviewing like Marvel TV shows." It's like, fuck off. Like, just don't review shit.
This is for Vic, right?
Is this the boyfriend?
What?
Misjudged Harry Potter.
Oh, someone else is not muted. What the hell?
Oh, man. Anyways.
I'm bummed that he's not here to talk to you.
But how far away is this? How long is he walking the dog for?
She's an energetic dog. So
I think you should get your go bag and leave him right now on the air with us. That's what I think. Get out of there.
Well, listen.
He's a good guy.
He must be a good guy. 5 years is a long time to be in a relationship.
I love morons.
I think, you know what? We're obviously not for everybody.
No, absolutely, and I respect that.
I've come to terms with that. I don't get it because I just think what we do is great. I think what Vic does is makes me cry laugh.
And Vic and he likes Vic.
Wait, what?
You gotta keep him.
But I mean, there's no Vic without me.
Right.
Does he understand that?
I've followed you guys long enough to know that, there's no describing that to him.
Some people really have a distaste for me. They see me, they want to punch. They've got a punchable face, as Colin Jost says, right?
But he does too, so I think that's why that he doesn't like you.
I know what it is. Wait, he sees my success and he says, "Why can't I be? That should be me, right?"
I should have thought of that.
Jealous.
Yeah,
I'm just a jealous guy.
Yeah, that's what it is.
I was dreaming of the past.
You might not love me.
And my heart was beating fast.
Well, hey, Tim, I think that you should encourage your kids to read Harry Potter.
We tried the movies. They were not really into them, actually.
They're probably
a little
young,
movies are a totally different thing. I started reading Harry Potter when I was 11.
I'm not reading that. She's anti. She hates the trans people. That writer.
Right. She's canceled.
Is she? I don't understand the whole thing. Yeah.
And she signed the letter.
Oh, she part of the letter?
Mad about.
Yeah, we can't trust anybody anymore.
Never know.
Nope. Canceled.
All right. Thank you. Listen, give your boyfriend my best. Tell him, like, from the bottom of my heart, I want him nothing but happiness, and I care about him.
Then give him a kiss from me, please.
All right. Let's take two more calls, and then we'll start the weekend.
Yeah.
All right.
Whatever that means.
All right, Luke. You're waving your arms like a maniac.
Hello.
Hello.
How's it going?
Hello.
Calling from Australia.
Oh,
this is how we talk to our folks down under, is do these nighttime shows, PM. Eh?
Yes, it's the best. I've missed so many shows for like years because I'm never up at 3 a.m. or whatever.
I used to get, when I first started doing office hours or back in the early days when it was random, which I miss, is get the random calls. I would get some like wasted Australian folks that were just like, it was 3 a.m. and they're just getting back from the pub, you know, and they're like, just like, you could tell they were out of it. Anyways, how can I help you today, tonight?
I've got a question for you and Vic, and if you got time, I got a little story for you guys as well.
Oh,
intriguing.
Bedtime
story. I'll start with a story. I don't know how interesting it'll be to you guys, but I think some of the listeners will like it. I don't know. I was at the Brisbane show that you guys did earlier this year. It was great. Funniest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Whoa.
Wow.
Matt.
Yeah, seriously. Big call, but it was like I was just pissing myself from start to finish. It was insane. Anyways, and then we were sort of heading back to where my car was, and we saw this like karaoke bar, and it's like 10:30 p.m. and I'm like, oh, I don't know, it's like an hour drive home because I live like a few towns away or whatever, and I was like, oh, let's go in, we'll do some karaoke. We end up there till like 1 or 2 a.m. or something, and then Mac DeMarco comes in, and sorry, I skipped part of the story, we had run into him at your show. Mac DeMarco, anyways, he comes in, and there's like maybe 15, 20 people in there, and he starts just doing karaoke, like right there in front of us, like doing this little performance. It was so awesome. And we got to like sing some stuff for him back and forth and everything.
This is after our show?
Yeah. Right after your show in Brisbane. Yeah.
That's a fun night.
Not right after it. It was like 2 a.m.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cause I was going to say, one of the few nights I went out after a show, I usually don't, but because I just don't know anybody in the town or am tired or whatever. I went out with Mac DeMarco that night, and we went to a bar, had a few drinks. I didn't really know him that well, but we were both in this, you know, foreign land together and had a nice time. But then I bowed out. I was like,
he's a young man. He can go hard. He's one of those Canadian.
Yeah. I just said, I got to get out of here. And then I guess, apparently he sounds like he went to a...
did karaoke.
All right, so what's your question?
Start of his night.
Question was, because I have a really similar taste in music to you and to Vic, it sounds like. I was just wondering if you guys listened to Max Tame Impala. I think their album Lonerism is like a masterpiece.
Tame Impala?
What you guys might think of it.
I'm sure you've heard them.
I have, but I can't think.
People love it. I don't know. Them.
What's their big hit? That I mean,
it's a little too modern for me. I don't.
Yeah,
it wouldn't be Tim's taste.
Yeah,
it'd
too dream poppy, electronic. I don't like that.
Yeah,
kind of
is there,
it's also, you know what it is. It's a generational thing for guys.
I like
my
Viola
age
Tango,
and Tim's age. We sort of like,
you know,
that sort of second or third generation from stuff we would have listened to 20 years ago. I feel like, and so. Now it just kind of sounds like other stuff that we would just listen to that stuff.
Right.
That's how I would sort of analyze that. Not to cut you
off.
Yeah,
fair enough.
I'm just reading an email I got from Donald J. Trump.
The great.
Just came in. Here it is. Breaking. Biden calls Trump the first racist U.S. president. Tim, can you believe it? The man who told millions of Americans, you ain't black, and used the term Blafrican Americans said that our president is racist. As if it wasn't already obvious, Joe Biden has absolutely lost his mind. President life. Trump is a champion for black voices. He always has been and always will be.
I kicked everybody's ass.
I love these emails I get. They're so funny.
Oh, I think Alexis's boyfriend is back.
Come on.
Oh,
man.
Really?
Dead.
Yeah?
Dead.
Oh, does he want to talk?
Yes.
Should we talk to him?
Sure.
There he is.
Hey, buddy.
This is
Mattel.
Hey.
How are you?
That's Tim. Not your boyfriend. What's up?
Is this your dad or your boyfriend? Yeah.
Oh God! Oh, for God's sakes, man! Really? Oh my God!
Off to a great start.
Oh, you ass! Now you're a cynical asshole.
I'm just having fun. I'm just trying to make people. I'm trying to make people laugh. There's nothing less cynical than that.
Where's Tim? But I don't see Tim.
I'm in the cowboy hat. I'm the good-looking guy in the cowboy hat with the tan.
Yeah, Tim. It wasn't. She was making small talk. I've seen a lot of your stuff, and I really admire and love you, and I just.
He's also really
high,
humorous, constantly a clown. So,
no.
What's your background, sir? What's your background? What do you do for a living?
Well, I'm a musician, not by trade, because that doesn't make any money. I run a coffee shop restaurant.
Oh, nice. Where are you calling it? Where are you at?
You heard of Ashland, Oregon?
I've never heard of Ashland, Oregon. No. Heard of the state of Oregon.
Yeah. That's a good thing, because it's a good thing that it's off the radar and that people don't hear about it. So,
where is it in the state, generally speaking?
Southern Oregon, right on the border of California.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow. That's no man's land down there. Mm. I mean, no offense.
Yeah. Pretty much.
It's
pretty much
no, really. Yeah. It's really nice,
beautiful place.
I've driven through it because we always go from Portland down to San Francisco on the bus, and that's usually when I'm asleep in the bus. You know, like there's just nothing there.
I look like a little afterbirth out of her shoulder right now. This is so
yeah, I'm sure you have driven through it a lot. Everyone does. It's right on the I-5.
All right. Well, we have to run. So good to see you, sir.
Hey, mommy, please take me home
and try. You know. Try to keep an open mind. That's always what I always say.
I'm sorry. It's good to meet you.
Yes.
I know Alexis really, really loves your stuff, and I'm fresh to it, so I'm new to it.
We'll keep working on it.
It's an acquired taste for a lot of people. And maybe it's something that you never will enjoy, and that's fine too. And we appreciate it.
He might like Office Hours. That might be a different way. Listen to this show.
Okay. Yeah. All right,
like
guys.
It.
Who else is on the air? Who else wants to communicate with me directly?
Who's got something interesting to say?
Hey, guys. It's Jeremy Renner.
I'd love to talk to Jeremy.
Hey, Jeremy.
Hey, Jeremy.
Hello, Jeremy. Hey, guys. It's Jeremy Renner.
I'm very excited to share some music with you.
Boy, Brendon was funny.
Thanks for coming.
He was really
yeah,
funny.
That was a nice.
Why is he so
L,
funny?
L from Bama. Yeah, you got something?
Hey, L.
Were you waving your hand or just moving your camera?
Hey, wait, can you hear me?
Yeah, loud and clear.
This I hope is everything's insane. Okay with Alexis and your boyfriend.
He looked a bit dangerous.
No, he's okay.
No, he seemed like a nice man.
Okay, so I figured that putting myself from Bama in the name would garner some attention. Do you talk to people from Alabama regularly?
Yes, regular every morning.
Every morning,
I have my Alabama's Anonymous call set for 9 a.m.
I figured as much.
That's why I think I'm wearing this cowboy hat. I love when the guy from Deerhoof gave you shit for you always playing that banjo, no matter if it's anywhere. That's
right,
not
the first one that's
New
offended.
York,
right. A hint of a southern accent.
Well, I know a little bit about Alabama. I know that Birmingham's quite a lovely place.
We play
no,
the show.
No. You got it all wrong. Birmingham is not lovely. It's all about Mobile, baby. That's where you gotta come. You gotta come to Mobile.
Okay, well we'll see. It sounds hot.
You run into Jeff Sessions at all? Is he ever you see him now?
Yeah, how's Jeff Sessions doing? Tommy Tuberville.
Tommy Tuberville. Hey, he's gonna go against old Doug Jones, so we gotta keep an eye on Tommy.
I'm gonna do a little skit with Vic.
Oh,
this
boy.
Is how the skit goes. Vic, your line is make up a name, any name. That's your line.
Make up a name. Just any name that comes to your head.
Tommy Tuberville.
You won.
That's the game.
You
already won. Tommy, well, I don't know, fucking Tommy Tuberville.
You got to check out this YouTube channel that I'm obsessed with right now. Soft White Underbelly is called.
Oh, yeah, that was pretty interesting.
And there's this this old warden executioner from, I don't know, 70s and 80s, and it's named Charlie Jones.
What's the prison?
The prison, Holman Prison.
Do you know just, Holman Prison?
And just the look of this guy is amazing. And just a lot of interviews, and so it's a good channel. Check it out.
Okay, Soft Mobile, Alabama. Is that on the Gulf Coast there?
Yeah, it's by the Gulf Coast. It's pretty close. It's like an hour from the beaches and all of that kind of stuff. It's boring. Honestly, it's not fun. But I'm a big fan, so I'm trying to like get you down. Nobody comes here. I've been like,
Sorry.
No one fun comes here. Like, you go to New Orleans, and that's like 2.5 hours away for me.
I'm worried that someone's going to barge into that door behind you, and there's going to be some kind of murder my show. I can't handle that.
Look,
doesn't it
I'm
seem
gonna
like
be
the
honest,
start of
it's
some
just,
kind
yeah,
of horror movie?
Just banging on the window.
It's not well locked. Someone could definitely. Door, but. I mean, I think things are fine. Seems pretty safe, and like the walls are like the walls are paper thin. So if somebody's coming up the stairs, I'm gonna know about it. Like, right. There's no doubt about it. There's no doubt.
Okay. Well, nice to talk to you, and we will get down to
do in Alabama? One thing. What's cool about it?
She has a question. She has a question.
Oh, you have a question.
All right.
No. I don't have a question. Oh. I do have questions, but they're questions you don't want to answer, like about On Cinema and stuff like that.
I'll answer anything. I don't care.
You don't care? Are you a little rummy in your tummy and you're like more eager to answer questions?
No, I just don't. There's no secrets.
Yeah, everyone thinks you won't answer, but like you'll answer pretty much anything or you just won't.
Look,
and then...
It's intimidating to like get called on because I'm like, is he gonna bully me? And am
He's
I gonna
very
like...
cynical? I know
he's a cynical guy.
Very cynical, but I'm thinking you're gonna bully me, and I don't know.
Bully me? Wow. I want to bully you.
Do people realize it's a show? And if you just let someone sort of flounder on their own and didn't react, it would be a very boring show.
Yeah, I'm just trying to keep things moving along.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Also, people are so
take it personally. Yeah, it's okay.
No. Everything's great. It's all good. I've taken up enough people's time. Let's just say I'm a huge fan, Tim. I will see you anytime, anywhere. Like you're my hero, and we'll just end it at that.
All right. That's a good idea. Thank you so much. I do appreciate it. I am a puppy dog, right, Vic?
That's right. You are a puppy dog. He's a sweet guy.
I'm not going to.
You come across hard sometimes.
Are you scared of me?
Yeah, I'm scared. I'm scared. People have said to me, like, I'm a little afraid of this guy. You know, like, he could be.
A lot of the Zoomers.
They mix your characters with.
Many
your,
are saying
no, you're just
this.
You're just a guy, just a nice, sweet guy. I mean,
what do you think? One more?
Yeah, one more. I mean, one this more. Is fun, you know, but
it's fun, but it's too. It's been a long time. Yeah, I have to pee again. And Carter Rock.
YouTube's going to run out of hard drive space. No. YouTube computer.
Carter Rock.
Yes.
Look at this guy.
Vic.
Where? I can't see him.
You'll see him in a second.
There he is.
Rocky roll, man.
Wow.
Vic, I have a question for you.
Look like Roy Wood. You know Roy Wood from The Move? You look, remind me of him little bit.
I don't.
Oh, all right.
I have a question for you, and I have a question for Tim.
All right.
So I was going back into the first like 60 episodes of Office Hours.
Jesus.
And you had predicted Roger Stone's outcome.
Oh yes, that he'd
and
be.
And so I want to know what you think.
Well, I called it.
I mean, that's a safe prediction.
I called it.
I mean,
it's a pretty safe prediction.
I predict that the sun's going to rise tomorrow.
Right. But I think, if I remember correctly, I may have predicted that it would be right after the election, like the day after, you know, just it would just get buried in news, you know, because Trump won or whatever, you know, or lost. And
well,
I forget what I said.
What's the term that What's the term that Trump used? Because it wasn't pardon.
It was commuted, which I think means. I don't know why he just didn't pardon, but I think commuted means he is a convicted felon, but we're just going to let him out, right? Isn't that something like that?
I have to be honest with you. I don't even know what Roger Stone did. He lied to the FBI.
He intimidated witnesses. He sent death threats to somebody that was a witness. But lying is ultimately what it was, I believe, to the FBI. And he's a liar. I mean, it was like finally caught up with him, but he's got friends in high places right now. So.
Yeah.
But yeah.
So do you think?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
No, all right, what's your question for me? That's what people want to know.
So a lot of people were asking you about Tame Impala, and you were saying that they're a little messy.
They're a little messy?
I love records.
I don't know. What did you say?
Techie. I don't know. I don't. My impression of them, it's a little electro-y, electro. I don't know. Play me something, Vic. I don't know.
Because those guys are super clean.
Super clean?
The past two records were super clean.
Okay.
Let's see.
And Lone Give me something and that, I mean, Speaker were,
if you got
were
a
little
if you got a hook.
Here's a new one. A new, well, 5 months.
I'm into Rod Stewart. Yeah, I don't like this. It's just like, it sounds like, it just sounds like Muzak or dance music.
We're still talking about, what's their name?
I like it. Sounds good.
He writes good tunes.
I can get into this.
I don't hear. I don't. Nothing's grabbing me. Sorry. I mean, what do you want me to say?
Wait, the chorus kicks in.
You might like their first album. I'm into this. A 60s vibe.
Yeah, I thought they were more like a 60s kind of thing. From what I remember.
I don't like 60s vibes either.
Yeah.
Really?
It's not for Tim, I could tell you.
I'm into it. I
like
this.
Thing, though, like,
but listen how good this is, guys.
With your guys' humor, though, I feel like. Because I just realized, you know, what Tim listens to. You know, he's a big Beatles fan, and a lot of, like, clean 60s music just doesn't match up with the kind of comedy and the kind of entertainment that you provide. And so I would think that he likes more messy shit.
He contains multitudes. Who's this?
What is that?
This is this guy named Christian Lee Hudson.
Oh.
Oh, this is Doug's pick, right?
You know whose music
listen,
tastes
can we just listen
known?
To this?
Sorry.
Listen to this, Vic.
I like food.
Nice.
I mean, I like that. That's, mm-hmm. That's that, yeah. That touches my heart.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. That dance music I could live without.
Right. Be My Baby is my favorite song.
You understand what I'm saying, though?
What?
Because you guys, the way that you guys are comics is totally different than what Tim you like musically.
Yeah, but there's a lot of the music I listen. There's a lot of the there's a lot of my music in my comedy.
Well, totally, but the music that you listen to.
I get what he's saying. He's saying like if you do wild comedy like that you're gonna like. Frank Zappa, like the assumption
right.
would be
yeah.
Frank Zappa
yeah,
and wild music.
You don't like Frank Zappa.
Right, right.
But also, you don't want to like.
You don't like Frank Zappa.
Something's your job. You don't want to like listen to stuff like your job, you know, like or what you do.
I like, I don't know. I like all kinds of stuff, but some stuff I don't like. That's all you can say.
Okay.
You know, I go through phases too. Like, I'll go through phases where I'm like, I'm just going to listen to Miles Davis 70s records because it's like, it's not song based. It's not like, you know, folky because I can burn out on that. So I'll like, I was listening to, I'm trying to pull it up, this fucking On the Corner record by Miles Davis.
So good. That whole era of Miles.
Yeah, it's
so
insane.
Before the, like,
and I like, I can just put that on like fucking drive or write. Sometimes I'll write music, not write music, but. Right, like if I'm working on an idea for a show, I will put that shit on, and
that,
I like you know
I like the working with the Miles Davis Quintet.
God, he's got so many records.
Live Evil, that's a good one.
Listen to this shit, man. Matt, do you know this shit, Vic?
I know
on the
some.
Corner, it's like
70s?
Scary music, man.
Yeah, is that John McLaughlin on that one?
Yeah, I think so.
I love that bass line.
So I dig that shit, man. I'm an interesting guy.
Someone in the comments said, wait, where are they saying?
I'm listening to Miles. I'm not listening to fucking Tame Impala. You know what I mean?
I love this. Alexis's boyfriend used to trip acid at Frank Zappa concerts.
Yeah.
Her boyfriend's 45.
Yeah. By the way, he looks 45 too. I mean, I don't look. I look 45. I'm 44, and I look. I'm 42. 23, 24.
I know. It made me feel pretty good about that.
That's so bizarre.
Sorry, yeah. Alexis's boyfriend.
What you're playing is so bizarre.
Right.
She what gave is that? Me okay.
It's, it's a. What was it on
He's
the corner?
He's a silver fox, Alexis.
What?
On the corner?
It's called On the Corner, yeah. That whole era, there's like five records from Bitches Brew up until a few
Live Evil in a Silent Way, hey, Bitches Brew.
In a Silent Way.
That
era. There's a...
Oh, you know what's amazing? The Bill Laswell... You would dig this. There's a Bill Laswell remix of the In a Silent Way sessions called Panthalassa that's like the best... Just it's like an hour perfectly segued mix.
Wow,
it's really good.
Yeah, I love so much. I love pretty music. I really do love. I love Joni Mitchell. I love like. I'm gonna listen to the new
like
Taylor
good
Swift.
Music. You like good music.
Sure. I like the new Rod Stewart.
Yeah, I was gonna ask you about that. Tim.
No,
Rod's duet.
You know who I love is William Rod Tyler. Stewart.
Who?
William Tyler.
Oh, he's that guitarist, right?
Yeah, he's like, it's all instrumental music.
Yeah.
But it's so great. Where was I? I was listening to one. The new, what's her name that I love?
Phoebe?
Phoebe Bridgers' record is unbelievable.
Should we take one more?
Yeah, one more.
One more. Bye, Carter.
Take care, man.
What's...
Oh, you'd love William Tyler, Vic. It's like it's all kind of score, like instrumental score music.
I'm gonna add it to my list.
Right and then
I say this with peace and love, but Tim's gonna know exactly what I mean. There's a certain look to a guy in the Zoom, and you know, like you kind of know the way
what
the call is gonna go.
Joe L. Dion.
Wave your arms around, Joe. Oh wait, John Effin.
He's got
oh,
a John. He Joe. Does have a beard, but he seems like a reasonable man.
Seems reasonable to you. All right, Joe.
Hi, Tim.
Hey, Joe.
And Vic and Matt. How's it going?
Good.
What's going on, hello, man?
Hell of a show tonight. Hell of a show.
What do you think? I mean, is this something we should do every once in a while? It's just like
absolutely.
It's much more relaxed.
Yeah, I can't get enough office hours content, especially it gets more ziti.
I don't think it's a podcast though. Do you?
It's like 3 hours. It wasn't too visual.
I will listen to it.
You
listen
I mean, to people can listen and not listen.
Yeah,
right?
That's true.
Yeah,
that's
true. Go to the next.
But yeah, Tim, I like the cowboy hat look. Actually,
you know what? I don't generally look good in hats, except for baseball caps.
You're looking.
But this hat looks good on me. I think.
Yeah,
I think this is the
a
right
one.
Hat.
It's a right curvature on the sides. Yeah,
it's a good fit.
It's a Stetson, and
is it a legit Stetson?
What's that?
Is it a legit Stetson?
Yes, sir.
John B. Oh, nice. Okay. It kind of brings me segues. What I wanted to actually ask you. So it's been kind of my dream to play drums in a country band, and I realized that dream about a year ago.
Oh, cool.
And tomorrow I'm gonna gather up the courage to buy my first hat and boots.
Whoa.
Does this mean that you have joined a country group, a country band, to play drums with them?
Correct. Yes. Cool. Yeah.
Wow.
Well, you know what I mean.
What kind of songs? Is it originals? Is it covers?
Right now we're just doing covers.
Sweet.
Kind of doing Bakersfield style stuff.
Awesome. I think Buck the first Owens. Time I heard the sound, the first time I heard Kenny Rogers, the first time I heard Kenny Rogers, man, I was like, you know, that was like glue coming through the radio. It's like honey. It was just like raspberry syrup from Home Depot coming through this. It was just beautiful, man. And Kenny Rogers is the reason I'm playing music. You know, like nothing's more real than him. People I've You know, people love Johnny Cash. They love Hank Williams. Kenny Rogers is my guy. He changed the way I thought about music. They always say that.
Yeah. Gambler era.
Yeah. It's funny. I was watching, I'm rewatching the Ken Burns
country music
documentary. Yeah. And that's like, oh my God. That's like every fucking interview on that.
I loved it though, but thought, it is.
Oh, it's amazing. Oh, it's so intense. Good. Absolutely. Learned a lot.
Did you watch the Garth Brooks Netflix thing that I recommended?
No, I don't. I don't know if I can handle that level of cringe.
It's the best.
The audio is amazing. It's
and so I was bad. I'm sort of making fun of that there when I'm doing my guy, but
oh for sure,
just
yeah.
A lot of this. Like, my mom saw me the first time. I knew that was gonna be. And that's the first time my daddy saw me. He said, "Son, you're gonna be a baseball player."
And isn't it all like he was in like some frat bar, like some fratty like cover band bar? There's
guys there pledging. Anyways, well, that's awesome. So you're gonna where are you playing anyway? I mean, where are you?
Well, we're in San Diego, so it's not the biggest country music town.
Doesn't matter.
So.
You're doing it, man. You made it happen. You're playing songs.
There's a couple of bands down here that are trying. Well, obviously we're not playing now, but we're trying to get something together. So when the Rona does decide,
you got any players in that group? Like you got a picker?
Steel?
You got any pickers?
We got lap steel. We got
lap steel is the greatest instrument, man.
Yes. Oh, it's so good. I'd love it. Yeah, I can't get enough of it. I don't know if you remember a band called Cashed Out. They were a Johnny Cash cover band. They played all over back in 2000s. But we have. They were. Yeah.
I mean, drumming for a country drumming must be on the relatively like compared to some other genres must be kind of. Pretty easy.
Basic.
Pretty basic,
yeah, I
right?
Because yeah.
Well, a lot of side stick.
Yeah, absolutely. Side stick and a brush. That's all I need.
Yeah. You got the easiest job in the band. I mean, those pickers.
Absolutely.
You ever go to Robert's Western World in Nashville?
No, I gotta go to.
That's my favorite. One of my favorite places in the world because they have the best. These guys are like savants and this playing all those songs, but. They're picking.
It's
super,
crazy.
Super high level playing every night there. Yeah. Every night there. I highly recommend it.
I hope to make it out there someday. And I guess Willie can too. He used to play with Buck Owens, still plays at Robert's Wrestling World every year.
It's legit. Like, I know people. It's on the tourist. It's like it's on that strip with all the other touristy bars. But. Yeah. I've heard from enough people that say, no, that's actually pretty good. It's like the band's good and they're playing the right music and, you know, it's a fun time. All right.
Yeah. Well, right on. I really appreciate you taking my Zoom.
Yeah, man.
Good luck to you.
Keep up the good work.
Stay in time.
Rock
you know,
on.
Don't speed up. Don't slow down.
Absolutely.
Follow the singer. As Ringo says, I just play along with the voice. That's what he says.
That's interesting.
Yeah. He says,
not many people do that.
The voice. I'm listening to
that's
John.
That's actually kind of what you have to do in country. Do you have to be appropriate to the song? Don't
be showboat.
No frills.
You don't hear a lot of drum solos in country music.
No. And I'm okay with that. I'm a lazy bastard. Yeah. So.
I mean, you don't even hear a lot of drum fills.
Keeping the beat.
All right, everybody. Thanks for joining us for our first annual game night.
You ever hear this song? Roly Poly? It's kind of mean.
Roly Poly.
It's about a fat guy.
Wow. That sounds like back in the day.
Eating every minute of the day.
Eating every minute of the day?
Should we go out on that?
Yeah.
We're going to get flagged for all
kinds of stuff. Yeah, this is it. Bob Wills is going to do it.
Oh, I love Bob. Have you pulled any Bob Wills drops for the show?
I'm going to need to. I'm going to make a note of that. Right
now. Listen, folks. Bob Wills is the drop master coming up.
The originator in the 40s.
That sound. I can't believe we haven't put that into the show yet. He did this Mickey Mouse. I'll just explain this real quick before we go.
I'll turn it down a little bit here.
Bob Wills, you'll know this if you watch the country music documentary. He was this 40s, 50s, like, mostly 40s.
Probably. 40s, yeah. Yeah.
Big, like, country swing act. And can you pull something up as an example, Vic?
Yeah, well, this is Bob Wills.
He would, he's basically like a big band, but kind of country style. And mm-hmm. and Bob Wills' signature move would be to go, ha ha! There'd be somebody else singing, but then he would go, ha ha!
Right. Like here,
see if we can get one. There's one in every song.
Ah! Let's see if this kicks in at all. Well, that's a slow one. Of course, now I'm like, having trouble finding it. Here. That should work. Come on.
I'm playing it, Mr. Leon.
A little bit there. Yeah. I mean.
Oh! There, if you listen, just put them on, folks.
It'll happen.
It'll make you smile.
Just put on like a Bob Wills radio station. It's
the
happiest
like
music.
He sounds like Mickey Mouse.
Yeah, yeah. And I don't think he... I think he sings and then he...
No, there's
no,
a
he's
singer
just
the
conductor.
In the band.
He's a conductor.
He's like the
yeah.
band leader.
Yeah.
Oh, one more time. Woohoo.
There it is.
All right. Thanks, everybody. Right. See you on Thursday.
Doug will morning. Be back.
Doug will be back. Doug is not the linchpin. Tonight was not, you know, don't be going, right. Yeah, the show sucked.
Don't grieve for Doug.
Doug wasn't on there, man.
Or the show.
It's just the way it is. We love you, and we wish you peace and love and to have a great weekend. Monday will be, if you're a member of the Patreon, John Lennon, a deep dive under John Lennon. Join patreon.com/officehourslive. Follow us there. And subscribes to everything you can get your hands on. All the best.
Good night.
Good night. Sleep well, world.
Fantastic, then.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Which ones are yours?
Oh, yeah.